Shut up.
Okay, here we go. This is what happens. Okay, let me share it. Wow.
You always talk over the music. Go.
You bitch.
All right, let me take these off.
Welcome to Chick Chat Comedy Podcast. We are here today with the fabulous Tim Gage. Oh, Carrie Caravis.
Carrie,
I'm always first. Patty, I'm always first.
You don't understand. I have to go in an order. What's the word?
OCD?
OCD.
Yeah.
I can't go here and then back.
Okay.
But let me start with the beautiful Carrie Caravis, who got her hair blown out today.
And it looks lovely.
And her nails did. She got her nails did.
Wow, did.
Very nice.
Did. I got my nails.
Now
did.
I'll go to the end with our special with our special guests, Tim Gage.
Hello.
Fantastic.
How's
everybody
doing?
Very funny. Irene Bremis, the fabulous.
I love you guys. Thank you for having me.
Also,
I'm so
very
excited
sexy
to be here.
Can I just say one thing about you? The first time I saw you on stage on a video, I said, "What's up with her arms?"
Oh, I
you
love
have fantastic
yes.
arms.
Thank you.
She's
even
a trainer.
I'm a trainer.
You were saying. Yes.
Oh, thank you.
Very nice.
Love
well,
you
were almost not here.
So
Kevin
sweet.
Brennan wanted to ax
I know
out.
He wanted to ax me. I know, and I feel terrible now. I feel guilty that I'm here instead of him.
Well,
already we're shot. Well, I'm starting off the show with a lot of
negative,
guilt already.
With a negative attitude.
Yeah.
Vibe.
Yeah, it's all right.
Okay,
you were confirmed.
Good. And Patty Rossborough.
I tried.
Because
I
you
want
never
Kevin...
say your name, Patty.
Oh, and Patty Rossborough. Thank you.
In Hi. The rec room. We're in the rec room.
We're in the rec room.
Adam on
Adam,
control.
Where's yes. your rec room located again?
Woodside.
Woodside, Queens.
Patty's been coming here for 6 months and still has
no
to
clue.
Has to GPS it.
I always GPS it. I don't know where I'm going.
Oh, I'm the same way. I have to GPS
it's
everything.
It's like there's 13. You got to get off 13 BC and then it goes 13 B.
Yeah, but after the fifth time, don't you kind of have it?
No.
Oh, my God.
No,
I
don't have
I
the
I always have to plug it
no,
in.
No, it's a 59. It could be 59th Street. It could be 59th Place.
That's right. It's
but hold
confusing.
On. But after you've done it for 7 months,
no,
don't
no,
you
do
know
once,
how to
know
get it?
Going.
Yeah, exactly.
Patty, don't feel bad.
Come on.
I'm exactly the same
I'm
way.
I'm really bad.
Tim's
right.
eating.
Leave me alone while I'm eating.
Tim is eating the fabulous food by Gyrolicious.
That's
yes.
right.
That Carrie brought in.
Yes.
Lemon,
see, I provide craft services for our guests.
And she provided craft services for my film. Remember we did that film together?
Yes.
She what did, film did you
she
do?
Did a, she did a film with Carrie. We've known each other.
It was called yes. A Story I Had a Little Lamb.
That's right.
Yeah.
And Carrie was extraordinary. I just want to say that Carrie is a phenomenal actress, like drama. She's
of course.
Incredible. No, there's a lot of comics. You know, just because you're a comic doesn't mean you can act. And Carrie was great. And the guy that Carrie played opposite with, Carrie,
okay,
you're going to love this.
Ready?
No,
hold on. Wait, let me okay, just say, sorry, okay. The guy fucking loved me.
He was in love with her. I made out with him, by the way.
By the way.
Because you didn't fuck you. I made out
okay,
with him. I
he
loved
was
him.
Hot.
Yes.
How
but
old?
I had a ball and chain boyfriend.
She had a ball and chain boyfriend, but I didn't. So I made out with him. He
oh,
loved
my God.
You.
Romano.
And let me tell you, you know, he's one of the stars of Taken, the movie on NBC.
Was he?
It could have been you.
What
was
he younger than you?
I could have had 3 kids with this guy. I could have been sitting right now in a mansion somewhere on Long Island in like yep. Brookville.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but no.
And you wouldn't be cooking no. lemon potatoes, which, by the way, were delicious. The first time I ever had lemon potatoes.
Oh, really? Oh,
I'd rather
God.
Have someone cook the lemon.
Pretty good, too.
The hummus is fantastic.
But I'd rather have someone cook that for me and be with Romano now.
Oh, right. Listen, Romano will always have a... He'll always love you, Carrie.
Not anymore.
And listen, yes, Carrie, he would love you. You look more beautiful now than
I don't know if you guys
then.
Saw my last Facebook Live, but I had a goat hair that
really?
Came extended this much, and I was pulling it.
Did you? You
and
did
you
not
pull,
show it.
I swear to God.
Yeah.
You could pull, and you could see my whole face... What? I know, because I'm undecided.
She's returning it, sweetie.
Well, I don't
you know nothing
it.
About women, sweetie.
I'm
nothing.
I'm undecided.
Adam, I was supposed to bring that up, okay? Just
you
between
do.
Me and you.
I'm undecided if I'm keeping
exactly.
it.
I think you should
that's
keep it.
That's what girls do. It's I really mean, actually very cute.
It's cute. And look, wait, hold. Can I stand up?
Please.
Yes.
It has this.
Very becoming.
Very cute, and it
very
gives you
cute.
A little hippie thing. I
yeah,
love it.
It's
very
nice.
May I just say, it's not just girls who do that. Paul Provenza. Remember Paul Provenza
yes.
on Comedy Central? He had his own show back a million years ago before my kids were born. And he would get, back in the 80s or 90s, he would get these silk shirts. He would sweat in them, everything, but he put the tag on the inside. It was on TV. And when he was done, his stylist would
okay,
return
no,
it back
I,
to the
I don't go to a wedding and, you know, whatever. And I'm
them.
Not sweating. And second, I'm just trying it on for 20 minutes or however long the show is. But just because you all said it was nice, I never do that. But just because you all said it was nice, I'm going to keep it.
I didn't say it was nice. Tim, I was the only one that said it. I didn't say anything about your outfit.
Well, what do you think about her outfit, Tim?
It's okay.
All right, well, now
what does that mean?
What is this? Did your mother buy you this in seventh fucking
I
grade? Because I swear to God, no, you've got those little lint balls on.
Can I just say,
but
Tim,
I love that his sweater matches his sneakers. There's like some thought, you know,
no,
there's
no thought
some thought
whatsoever.
Going into this outfit. I don't buy it for one second. You have like a black shirt inside a gray sweater, which matches the exact check mark on your gray, on your sneakers. Sorry about that, right?
You know what? I remember
Kevin Brennan dresses me.
It's almost OCD.
We love Kevin Brennan.
He throws it out.
I know. We should have brought him here today because he's
We could have done five.
I know. We could have done five.
I'm so sorry, Kevin, that I'm here, that I exist.
We should have had
Well,
Kevin
maybe he'll
here.
Call in.
We don't have a call
oh,
in.
Maybe he'll write in.
Remember, we're...
Maybe he can tweet in.
Pat, this is $50 a week. It's, you know.
Wait a minute. The first time I saw Tim Gage,
yes.
First time I met you, you were like the Geico caveman. Mm-hmm. He had hair down like Benjamin Franklin. He used to do a joke about Benjamin Franklin. He would wear big, baggy khaki pants. Mm-hmm.
Ugh,
big,
I remember.
Woolly shirts.
Oh, now you remember,
and just
huh?
a beard and hair.
And wow. He had a bald head, so
yes.
The hair started from the sides,
right.
like
Bozo.
Bozo.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Wow. But it was straight. But can,
very
we,
funny,
have, can we get a clip of that? We're not in that kind of studio. Can we put up a clip of old?
Yeah. I don't think so.
All right, you can Google him, Tim Gage, and you will find. First of all, this is what you don't have a fucking Facebook.
No, I don't.
That is unbelievable.
You're my hero. No, fuck that. He is my hero.
Wait a minute, but he's an entertainer.
Well,
anyway, I Google his name. I can't. 5,000 million Tim Gages come up. This asshole doesn't. I'm trying to get a hold of him. I can't. You know.
So you tell me to call. I call Omnipop, and I'm on the phone with Omnipop for an hour, and then I call him up, and I go, "Oh, listen, here's the information." He goes, "Carrie already called me." I go, "Fucking Carrie told me." Omnipop, and I'm on the phone for an hour trying to get a phone number.
Yesterday,
and you found the number.
She was screaming at me because she was mad at you because you told her to get in touch with me.
Okay, because you know why? Because I couldn't find your number, and it turns out you're in my contacts somehow.
Because it sinks right away, Carrie.
14 years ago.
No, but you know what happens?
14 years ago.
On my iPad, my iPhone, I look up people's names and they're not there. They're not on my contact list. And then all of a sudden they'll call me and their name will pop up and it's like they're on my contact.
Because it takes a while to sync. That's why. It takes a while to sync, yeah.
Or maybe when you change phones. When you change phones.
Yeah, that's a new phone, by the way.
Well, it's
get out
nice.
Of town. You bought a new phone.
Well, what happened was my husband's phone broke. So I gave him my shitty phone that had the glitches. And I ended up getting a new one. I'm like, honey, look, I got your new phone. But meanwhile, I gave him my leftovers.
Good girl.
You're very sneaky, Carrie.
Yes.
Good for you.
This is annoying the shit out of me.
God.
Right.
Well, are you going to keep it or not?
I'm keeping it.
All right, then take it off.
You taking it off? You're making a commitment.
Well, don't take it off because
don't
you
pull
may,
it. You'll make a
you'll
hole.
Rip it, and then you're that's
there
brava.
You well, you could still
very
actually
nice.
Put it back on.
You could put it on another shirt.
I really,
back.
I really
that's
like the
that
fact.
That is so. Dishonest.
You could put take this. It's a little now. They're dumb. These people because I'm one of those people that get over. Mm. So. Here's a little thing. All you have to do is get another one of your shirts that you hate and you're sick of wearing and just clip it on there. Go like that.
No, never.
They'd have to be, oh, wait, actually, yeah.
And the receipt.
You're right.
Go like this and go, I'm bringing this
oh
back.
Oh, my God,
how
you're
is
right.
she going to know
the barcode is on it. I didn't know that the barcode is on it. You're
have
right.
you seen some of the people that work at Kohl's?
yeah, exactly.
They,
you're right.
No, they
no,
don't
but
discriminate.
True.
Anybody.
You know,
my dog can go into there and go, I want bark three times, and he's behind the counter bringing it in.
I had a friend who would wear leggings for a year.
Oh,
and they
come
would literally
on.
Deteriorate in the crotch, and she would bring them
ew,
back.
In the crotch?
Well, you know, you wear them, you know, they
ew.
Rip, you know what I mean? They just three rip right. open, whatever. And
my
she would crotch
would not
them.
Deteriorate.
She would return them. I forget what store, like Macy's or whatever it was. She would always be able to return them.
Wow.
She would fight them. She goes, let me talk to your manager. Let me, she goes, they have
I'm
a right, run in them.
I'm
they have
writing,
a hole in
them. Right, I'm writing to corporate.
And they would let her, and they would give her money.
I wow. found a pair, you know when you go through the, like the 60% off rack? Yes. I find a pair of pants, and they're clearly one of those crotch ridden, eaten, whatever, and destroyed.
No. I love that.
It kind of looked like this sweater.
I like
and
this sweater.
It actually still smelled the like the nice. Person's, you know, whatever, body odor. So I go to the girl, I go, do you see anything wrong with those? And she's like, no. No, I'm like, nothing? You don't see anything wrong with these. She goes, no. I go, they're used! They're used, you idiot! People like you, you know, it makes it easy.
It's
it makes
bad.
It easy.
It's bad.
I have my daughter's boots on.
I'm hoping
very
to, cute.
To get that tag after the show's over, actually.
Justice.
Wow, those are cute.
What are those? Are those feathers? Oh, no, they're fur. No,
they're fake fur. They're Justin. I had no black boots.
Justin, the
Justice.
Little kid store.
Justice.
Justice, the little kid store. That used to be store. Called, what
What's
did it
Justice?
Used to be?
I don't know
Brown.
About this store. Is this a child store?
Yes, my kids used to, it used to be called something else when my kids were little, and then it became Justice.
Wow, so I should go shopping there. I was shopping at Forever 21. But this looks a little fancier.
It's sad that I still
that.
Shop at Forever 21.
Sweetie, and
they're really
so
not
do
that.
I.
They're really not that sturdy. Like you could tell, they're like made in China and they're garbage. But they kind of they're perfect
they're cute.
For right now.
Right,
and then you know they were like what?
They're like
$29?
They're fake suede. They're fake suede.
Right.
They're these are fake suede too.
They're
it's
fake
just like
Uggs.
Fabric. It's just fabric. You know,
right.
It's
those
like,
are really cute.
What they're thrift right. store did you get those?
Stop oh. it! These are very
no, they're
very
new.
High end.
Yes.
No, they're not. They're cheap. But you know,
but like, they look high end. Though.
No, they don't. Don't.
Of
be
course they do.
Why is it real,
though?
Stick your
though.
Foot out. Let me
real.
See, Patty.
Sorry.
Stick your
these
foot
are
out.
Cute.
Very cute.
Yeah,
stick your
cute.
Foot out.
They have like a chunk well, heel.
You know, we don't.
But really... I do go to thrift shops a lot. Carrie knows
no,
me.
Because,
see, they
because
say...
thrift shops have really great quality things, but the only problem
I love
is they're used. Of course,
they're used,
people,
but
yeah.
I don't mind wearing used stuff as long as they're not shoes because they say.
Yes, the
oh,
Greek
what do they
thing,
say?
You can't wear somebody else's shoes.
You can't wear somebody else's shoes because you're buying a dead, you can't wear a dead person. Mm. They don't know if the person's dead. Like, let's say the person died and they donated all the shoes to thrift. Now you're walking in dead man's shoes.
Right. Wait a minute, is this a Greek thing?
Yes, it's a Greek thing. It's also, it's not even just dead, it's also the negative if they just any negativity can be transferred
really
from
I've never heard of such
well,
a thing
now yeah. think about it next time you go to buy a thrift
also
shoes.
Clothes
I'm Irish
just
I'm happy
stop
I got
it.
A brand new pair of shoes sorry you died but I appreciate you giving me your shoes
right
hey
exactly.
I, if they're dead
beggars can't be choosers
I have bought yeah. the bet well I sell vintage clothing I buy oh. the best vintage clothing
vintage
from dead
clothing?
People.
What do you mean you buy? I didn't know that you sell vintage clothing.
I sell in Rhinebeck, New York at the Beekman Arms Antique Market.
Wow.
Upstairs,
no
I sell
one's
vintage
going.
Clothing. I know no one's going. But anyway,
Rhinebeck?
Rhinebeck, New York. Come on.
That's
I always
far.
I buy from dead. That's where you buy your clothes, from
yeah,
dead people.
You get it from
so
dead
what do
people,
you do?
Yeah.
You like look at the obituaries and you go, you know,
no.
Natalie so-and-so dead age, you know, 70. Oh, she might have a good selection or 50 or whatever, however old she is. You run over there and you
no.
knock on their door. You go to the funeral. You meet
no.
the family.
No, I have an in. I have an in. There's a girl who does the
that.
Sales and then she calls you out and then she lets me in a day early and then I get first dibs. On the dead person's shit.
No, but is it, do you, do? But is that real? Are you serious?
Yeah,
you,
I really
do.
Do
you go to like, do people donate clothes to you? No,
no
it's not a donation
No, you
thing.
Go to an
you
estate sale.
Go to an estate
sale. The
estate
sale is the sale of the dead people.
The dead people.
And you go in their house and it's like sort of sad. You like go through their drawers.
Do
and
people
their,
ever,
and
look,
do,
and
do
it's
do you ever
so
get
sad
caught?
Because I go to estate sales and you see like the stuff that they're collecting for years that
Horrible.
They went, their memories, everything in the family, like the door, it's usually the
I
fucking
know.
Door.
I was going to say there
that
should be conflict.
Piece of
yeah.
shit. And she's like, you know, we don't want any of your mother's stuff. And they'll put everything up for a dollar, you know, or whatever, like $20 for
yeah.
like something that the woman, you know,
yeah, something memorable,
loves.
Symbolic.
Or they think it's better than it is. Like they'll go, oh, this was my mother's
it's
mink.
A collector's item,
and it's some shitty yeah. 70s mink. You know, there's good
that
mink,
smells.
Some shitty mink.
That's
yeah,
my
yeah.
mother. My mother thinks everything's a collector's item. That's
yeah.
my Greek mother.
She would be wrong. She
I know,
would be
she
wrong.
Is wrong.
So we have two Greeks and two Irish today.
Two
my
drunks
darling.
And two sluts.
Yeah.
My dear.
Perfect matching pairing.
I feel like I'm at my cousin's confirmation party or my nephew's confirmation
Why
party.
Why is that?
And I just went over and said hello to my aunts. And I'm like, I got nothing more to say. Is there a ball game on here?
That is so hurtful, Tim Gage. Are you suggesting
he's bored?
As old as your aunts?
No, I'm just...
That is
yeah,
so
maybe
sad.
I am. I don't know.
All right, let's talk about boy things with
there
Tim.
There is no boy things.
What's a boy thing? Let's talk about your career. We noticed that
what
you
career?
Are... You,
well, here's what I'm
You're here with us well, today.
I took
exactly.
a half a vacation
That's a big
day.
Step.
Here's a boy
I
thing.
I took a Go half ahead. A day
He's got some
day.
Sort of melanoma thing growing on his face, and he hasn't taken it off. Now, wow. you and I or her Stop. Would have definitely had that thing removed.
Right. Wait, I don't even see
well,
it.
Well, it's not dark, so I don't think you... It's just no,
show me your melanoma.
It's a red thing.
Okay, look, show it to
the... Has it changed shapes?
That is not...
Has it changed shapes?
I have no idea. I'm going to the... I didn't...
Is it raised? Is it raised?
Yes.
Yeah, it is a bump.
Oh,
you're Irish. That's the number one.
Really?
That's
right. Your skin can't take the sun. You know that. Like, Irish skin is cheap skin. It just can't take
whoa,
the sun.
Whoa,
I'm sorry.
Whoa,
I didn't mean that. Wow,
whoa.
That just popped out. I'm such a dick.
Whoa.
What a cunt. I'm so sorry. That's rude.
Unbelievable. Sorry. Came here to be abused like that.
I didn't mean
I never
to
heard
say
that,
that
Irish people
I
had
cannot,
bad skin.
I cannot cheap. Believe that you didn't, like, you don't want to check
that.
On that? My fiance has a thing. He had what? A thing on his face. Brown.
Oh, you're engaged?
Oh, yeah, yeah. 15
For
years.
17 years.
15 years.
Yeah, so was I. Therapy. Fixed that. Go
Did
ahead.
You finally get married?
Yeah, after therapy. I seriously had to go to therapy for that to happen. But anyway, I didn't mean to interrupt.
No, we'll okay. Yeah. We'll talk about it. So it's like a big, long, it just brownish. And I'm like, will you go get that checked out? Get it. But it's not raised. But why don't they? That's the first thing I would do is get that thing checked out.
Right.
I don't understand, man.
Yeah.
Have
yeah,
that removed, right man. Get something to remove yeah. that okay. off your face.
Either that or pencil it in brown and have a beauty
there
mark.
You go.
I think that's pretty. I'm like a male Cindy right. Crawford.
Oh, my God. Remember beauty marks?
What? It's in between a wart and a zit. It's like,
right. I don't know
like
what
it's
it
brown.
I don't know. You got to get right. that taken out.
I'm older than everyone, but there was a show on TV called Honey West, and she was a detective, and she would do kicks and like beat everybody
I don't
up.
Remember well, this?
This was in the 60s. You weren't Sorry. Born yet.
She's and, only 52.
That's right. I forgot. And she used to have a big mole, and my sisters and I would put on fake moles like that. I love
oh,
that
I
look.
My friend had a zit on her face, and she would put the mole in it.
Because she's smart.
And she had the traveling mole. Every time she got a zit, the mole would be
That's
here.
Right. Get she's here, smart. Then here, then my here. Mother, my mother too. My mother did it. She actually tried to break off a pencil in her skin so that she could have a permanent. I know.
Whoa. That's
we
terrible.
Do for beauty. She's crazy.
That's terrible.
All right, go. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
We want to know about
I
boys.
I took a half a vacation day to come
Get
here.
Get the fuck out. Did you and, really?
Yes, I did.
Wow.
Yeah,
thank
wonderful.
You.
Thank you. And, so tell us now, you're cousins with the famous Colin Quinn.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Now, how does that feel to be under his...
like under his tutelage.
How about he's under my
no,
tutelage.
No, wait a second. He's the famous one in the family, and then it's you.
So that tells you how pathetic our family is.
Who started first, you or him?
He did.
He did.
Mm. Oh.
He's a lot older than you, too, right?
Yeah, about maybe... I'm older than him.
Does he take you on the road?
Yes,
do you work with him at all?
Him. Yes.
You're okay. older than Colin Quinn?
Yes. See, I'm 6 months
you know
older,
what it
so
is?
He has
You're
to listen
immature
to me.
Irish twins.
What? Mm-hmm.
You act more immature than he does. He's very...
So
you don't know how much that hurts, because to me, every time I talk to him, it's like a 12-year-old kid I'm talking to.
Now, you are yes. opening for him now, yes?
Yes.
That's,
oh, that's
so
great. That's
he
great.
Is taking you under his wing,
well,
yes?
He has now, finally. I remember. Tell the story what happened with the show.
What? That was you. You
yeah, were... tell him the show what happened.
What happened?
Now, I hung out.
She was doing tough crowd. She comes and goes, I told your cousin he's an asshole. And
no,
he should
that's
have you
not
on
what
him.
Happened.
All right.
Okay, what happened?
So
what happened?
I did Colin's show, Tough Crowd, okay? I did it with Mario Cantone, which no one got a word in fucking edgewise. Okay? Fucking guy doesn't shut up. Anyway, we had to do two takes because the first one was all about Mario. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so...
You're kidding. They redid it?
Yeah, they had it was so over the top, gay and Mario that we had to stop.
What would you expect if you're going to put Mario Cantone on the show?
Yeah,
that's now, where it's going to go.
Right, but you know, none of us got to talk, and then mm-hmm. they go, okay, so they let that segment go. Then they tell the crowd again, okay, we're going to do another take. So they come in and they go to Mario.
We're going to eclipse Mario this time. Like,
take
shut
it
up, stop
down.
It.
Yeah. You're kidding.
Five notches. So now he's like, what? you know. And telling him to take down five notches is telling him to turn it up, baby. Turn it up. Right. So anyway, I mean, and you know how Colin is. So
no, I don't.
Whatever, we do the show. Colin rolls with everything.
Yeah.
So we do the show, whatever, whatever. So now everybody's getting on the show. So I'm at the Cellar, either hosting or hanging out and performing every night with Colin, with all the great comedians.
Right. And I'm on Long Island.
Well, you lived on Long Island. You lived
doing
on the
a
island.
Tuesday mic at a tea house.
But you have children at the time.
Yes, I did.
I did not have children. And I was living that life, which was a great thing to do at the time. So what happens? I see this one guy on, and he's so horrible. Now, Tim Gage is so funny.
Thank you very much.
No, you are. But I used to take you everywhere with me.
Yes,
didn't
we
I?
Did. We had a lot
He's
of fun.
Very funny.
I'd be until like, you met Sam.
We didn't have that kind of fun.
My fiance thinks you're very funny.
Well, no, he's hilarious. Says, he's hilarious. You're very but funny. I would tell Ingenio I want him to open for me. I would bring him everywhere. Right. So anyway, so I'm watching the show with Colin, and I see this comic from L.A. who sucks. Bag of balls.
Who was it?
I don't remember.
Oh, sorry.
It could have been any fucking hack from the right there. So I now I'm hosting the Cellar. And now Colin's up next. So as I'm running up the steps to, I just put the, Colin walks in with that, right? And we intercept in the hallway on the steps, and I grab him and I throw him up against the wall.
Oh, I didn't know you did that. Really?
Oh my God. I threw him up against the wall, and he's like, what's the matter? What did I do? I go, what did you do? You put every piece of shit hack on that show, and your cousin, who's hilarious, who I just got off the road with the last weekend, I go, is not on the show. You should be a fucking shame to yourself. You're a piece of shit. And I went off on it.
What did
and
you say?
And then that was
I
it.
I put me on a show.
And then that was it.
Oh, wow.
He did it?
Thank
God.
Yeah, someone called me, and they were like,
Carrie.
Can you do the show Thursday? Thursday.
Yeah, and they go, can you send us a headshot and what your feelings are, you know, like what your personal things are. And
I can
like,
give you a blood sample, a DNA
Colin's
sample.
I'm going to do it
cousin.
Or not, you know? It's
Wait, but it was that was a Monday night. Like, we had just gotten off from, like, Connecticut or something. Monday night, I see Colin. Yeah. Or Tuesday night, he gets the phone call on.
I don't know when.
No,
I got
it was
the phone
Monday.
Call.
You got the phone call the next day. And then I get a phone call. And he's going, Caravis. Did you say anything to my cousin? I go, I threatened him last night. He goes, I got a call today. I'm doing the show Thursday. I was like, wow. That was quick.
That was good. So, and now?
Now I've done nothing else.
No, you open for him all the time now, right?
Right, but he's hilarious. But he's hilarious.
Very fun.
Thank you.
Can I just say, this guy is hilarious.
Thank you. I've had a lot of fun with her on the road. We've had a lot of fun on the road. Her jokes and stuff.
Craziness.
Bringing her up.
The bingo. You know? How about tell them the story about when I went to we were doing the fucking Connecticut gig and I was at Mohegan.
She was at Mohegan Sun. And
no,
gambling problem.
No, she does. She does a little.
Oh yes, she did.
But she had like half her family with you too.
No, it was like all my groupies.
Yeah, right.
Right.
Yeah.
So now the Friday night groupies. The show started at 9 o'clock. Yes. It was two shows.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. One on Friday, one on Saturday. All right.
I think it was one on Friday and two on Saturday, because the first show on Saturday was at 7, and you thought it was like 8 o'clock or something.
Right, so I'm closing the show, so I'm not worried, right? So I'm at the Mohegan Sun, and my phone's ringing, and I'm like, what does Gage want? And he goes, where the fuck are you? I go, I'm at Mohegan Sun, and he starts laughing. Because he loves shit like that. You love shit like that, right?
Anyway.
So now I'm like, what do you mean? He goes, the show started 20 minutes ago. I go, what the fuck are you talking about? I go, isn't the show starting at 9? Or whatever it was, 8? Who starts a show at 7?
So they all of a sudden,
now it's 7:20, and I'm not there because I'm thinking I got another half hour, and by the time I will get there at 8:30, right?
Right.
No, so it's like 45 minutes away, an hour.
Right. So I'm thinking I'll get there 30-40 minutes, whatever. So all of a sudden, he's like, "I'm serious, Caravis. Get your fucking ass." I go, "Gage." I go, "I'm gonna get there. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. I don't want to hear
it." The show didn't stop.
So all of a sudden, he goes, listen, and he puts the phone, and I hear the crowd laughing at the feature act. And I'm like, what?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I go, you gotta stretch, and you got to stretch him, and you got to stretch everybody. There was no guest spots, so it was just, I was up next.
Yeah,
in 10 minutes, I'm up, and I'm 45 minutes away. So now I'm trying to gather my people, because then one's gambling.
And
the
if you
crap.
Had Facebook, you could do Facebook Live from your car.
You
like
could have.
Still, so, yeah.
I don't know if you've ever done Mohegan Sun, but that casino, you could run, and it's like, you know how the
in
whole.
In Wilkes Barre, right? That one?
No. In
no, this
Ledger.
Is Connecticut.
Oh, the Connecticut one. Oh,
so
okay.
You're running, and the hallways get longer, and you're right, running, right, and the hallways get. And it felt like I was never getting. And then you got to get your valet parking ticket, and you got to get your car, and you got to wait. And I'm like hyperventilating. So an hour goes by, and I go running in, and you hear boom, 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 boom down the steps.
But
I,
you fell down the steps.
It's hysterical. I'm on stage, and I'm like, oh, it sounds like your headlight is here.
It was loud, but I'm hearing him go.
Because it was in the basement of a.
How much time
restaurant.
Did you do in between? 45 minutes.
Yeah, 45.
You had that much time?
No. Yeah. I heard this. And when I was 7, like he told them every story in the book of what he did in his life. Damn. It was hilarious. And then I fell down the steps. And I don't remember if I broke my heel, but it was so bad. And
but
you enjoyed, you loved every
I
minute
love when
of
people
it.
Are tortured.
You loved it, especially because it was me. You loved it. Yes. You thought it was great.
No, we played bingo, I think, that afternoon.
No, maybe the Sunday or whatever. I tortured you with gambling. We must have done another gig with the bingo hall.
Hilarious.
You know what? May I just say something? You are not on anything. You're not on any sites. You don't do shit. This woman, Irene, you're on everything. You're on Facebook. You're on Twitter. You're
I know,
on...
but I have so much respect for you. I do. I think that social media becomes so overwhelming, doesn't it? Don't you think?
Carrie loves it. Uh-huh. You're on it all the time, right? You do your movies.
Yeah, you're on it all the time.
I take a crap.
Facebook Live.
I've got
you
live take,
you've
going.
Got Facebook
I know,
Live.
I've got
to
go.
Yeah, no.
Now,
to me, I force myself to put something on it. It's like I have to think of something, and I'll say, okay, today I'm going to put this up. And I always want to put up stuff that's political, and then I know I'm going to have people hating me and saying all horrible things. Okay, can I read one of her tweets? Can I read one of your tweets?
Go right ahead.
This one, I love this. Okay, this is when I knew that I liked you. Trump, wait a minute. Oh, this one I like. Okay, you all know about Milos Yiannopoulos.
I know something a little about
him. I love
Yiannopoulos.
You do not.
I do.
Carrie.
He's a fucking asshole. Tell me you're lying.
Oh, my God. First of all, he's adorable.
No,
he is
Carrie.
Adorable, though.
Carrie.
I'm sorry, he's
I
cute.
Love him.
You
but
know
he's a fucking
hey,
asshole.
Hold on a second. Why? Because he tells it like it is?
No,
no, come on, because he's a racist
fucking
Nazi.
Whining.
Carrie, you made that.
He called Amy Schumer fat? I mean, why?
No, Carrie. He's talking about having sex with 13-year-old boys.
Yeah,
do you know
exactly.
That part?
Molestation. Yeah, he's actually.
You didn't
hear
that part.
There you go.
Okay.
He's like, oh, totally,
well,
yeah.
Isn't that allowed
perpetuating
in some
molestation.
Countries?
No, where he's in America, and he's from England. Neither country is he allowed to have sex with 13-year-old boys.
Right.
So he's talking about 13-year-old boys. He gets in trouble. He has to step down from Breitbart. Okay.
Right.
So anyway, here's this woman's,
and that's
Irene
Bremis'
post.
Yeah.
I'm sure he gave Sandusky solace. She's a bigger cunt than Ann Coulter, if that's possible. Hashtag Milos Yiannopoulos, however you say his name.
Is he great?
Thank you. Yes,
he is great.
Yes.
No wonder you like
that
him. What the hell?
He is in his name, if we have to break it down, right? It's, of course, it, you know.
Yiannopoulos.
Ass-fucking was the most embarrassing thing about Greeks. Now it's him. I'm sorry, Carrie. This guy is like really, I mean.
He's bad. He's bad to the bone. He's pretty bad.
Outside of
being a Nazi. And he's
a Nazi. He's alt-right. He's alt-right.
I only saw one of his tweets about
Nazism.
No, I saw one of his rants about he called some girl not funny. And how
Lena Dunham, he calls her fat and he says horrible things about her all the time.
No, but he had a point. He said, you know, America coddles, you know, overweight people and it's saying it's okay, you're big. And it's not okay when I'm big, because when I'm big, all my cholesterol levels are high. I'm ready to fucking drop dead when I'm big. Mm-hmm. And we're talking about this country has the fattest people in the world.
But he's not saying it like you're concerned and you're sweet.
No,
you're coming from a loving place. No, this guy's a hateful
dude. He's nasty.
He's a nasty asshole.
All right, well, maybe. All
you're
right.
A beautiful
so
person.
I kind of
totally
thought
different.
He was.
Handsome. Yeah,
you kind of thought he was handsome.
Carrie, I'm going to say he's kind of cute. He's totally a fag. I'm
he's
like,
so
listen,
cute,
can somebody fucking put up a mirror and show this guy that he's gay? Why is he even like this?
He's anti-gay.
He's like what's her name? Caitlyn Jenner, even worse than her.
That's right. It's like, but I feel like.
Well, he might be slightly crazy.
He is crazy.
Definitely.
But I feel
there's
like
no
the conservatives always try to find someone who will speak out against their own people. Like, he's gay, saying horrible things about gays.
I know exactly. That's
he says
what I
horrible
mean. Somebody
things
hold
about
up
gays.
A mirror.
He goes,
gay,
I would, he goes, I would never hire a gay person because they are always late, they're terrible workers, and they're promiscuous. It's like,
really? But I like to fuck small children.
Yeah, but I like to fuck 13-year-olds, yeah, and
well,
that's
that
okay.
That doesn't make him gay. Yeah. It makes him a pedophile.
Well, that, yeah, but he is well. Gay. Totally he wears pearls and yeah, stuff. Yeah, I mean, he's gay. Okay.
I just saw his one thing.
But he
that
does
was
things
two
with
days
the
ago.
That
was
just naughty.
That was the only thing I saw.
All right, he is out of his mind though. But and he got in trouble. You know, Bill Maher brought him on his show, and someone who was supposed to go on, I can't remember who, wouldn't go on the show,
right,
because he says he's so terrible. Yeah. But Bill Maher feels like everyone should have a place at the table, right, even if you're horrible and vile. You know, you should have something
that's
to
Bill
say.
Maher is.
That's what. Yeah, that. But I love the Bill Maher.
I love
okay,
Bill Maher.
Here's one more. Here's one more that you did. Here's your other.
Bill Maher wears makeup.
They all wear makeup.
Thank
okay.
You.
No,
thank
no.
One guy on TV
you,
doesn't wear makeup.
No,
that's
no.
Not like.
Listen,
some...
hold on a second, oh, Irene. I opened for that guy twice.
Sorry, sweetie. I love you so much. Okay.
I opened for this fucking weirdo.
Okay. Oh, wow. Stop. I love him. I love him.
I'm sorry.
I love it.
I opened
like it
for
girl.
Him twice. Mm-hmm. He's a weirdo kook, and he sits in his dressing room, and now we opened up, I opened up for him twice. So first theater, I go in, and I look, and they're all like 100 years old. Watching his show. So I always have to peek out in the theater to see what my crowd is. You know, I get nervous. I don't want to offend anybody, right,
really?
With my language.
Oh,
really? I'm sorry. It was
so
funny.
I go.
It was why we love you, by the way. Love you for it.
I go. I do the show. It's great. Whatever. I
what
get
did
out.
You see when you looked out the window, out the stage? What was the audience like?
About 100-year-olds.
You're not gonna do the look.
Well, that's them in the wheelchair or like half dead. So I come out and he opens his door and he goes, "Who are you?" I go, "I was your opening act." And he goes, "Oh, what's your name?" Like he was just very douchey.
He's arrogant.
He's arrogant. Hold on. I'm not impressed with you. I could give a fuck who you are, whatever. Yeah. So he's wearing a full face of makeup. So
like eyeliner and mascara?
And he's like, "Where do you work?" I go, "Eyeliner, mascara, blush, the foundation, the whole."
Oh, right. Because a foundation and blush I could see for TV, but
a theater?
Stage? A theater. Right.
Well, a 90-year-old. He goes, "How is the crowd?" I go, "Dead and old."
Right.
And I go, "They were 100 years old, but they were fine." And all of a sudden I looked at him and I go, "Are you wearing..." Because he
you
tried...
did not say
no,
that.
No, here's what well, he did. I mean, he tried to slam Nancy Redman, who I fucking love.
I mm-hmm. love Nancy yes. Redman too.
All right?
Very
and
good.
He goes, "Where do you work in the city?" I go, "I don't know. Everywhere. The cellar, Dangerfields." He goes, "Oh, Dangerfields. Is Nancy Redman still there?" And I was like, "Yes, she is." I go, "Are you wearing makeup?" You know it's a theater show. And not
well,
a movie.
What did he say?
Well,
maybe he thought it was a musical.
He
sweetie.
Goes, "Well, the lights already. Are too bright and yeah. I look too white." I go, "Well, now you look weird. Now you're ready for the coffin."
You
because
did
that's how
not.
Much fucking, no, I didn't say that. At, well, no.
No, but you said that.
She didn't have to say that.
The second time I opened for him, I didn't even run into him. Uh-huh. Which was fair. Why would he have me again? Open for him again.
Maybe you did a good job, darling.
Maybe you did a good job, sweetie.
I insulted
maybe
him.
He likes
so
to
what?
Be insulted. He likes
maybe.
People who push back, you know?
Exactly.
He likes it.
You know, maybe he needs
I
to
go,
be told.
I judge a person by how they are off stage. And if you think you're hot shit off stage and you're just a dick.
Well, right. He does have a whoa. Reputation right. for being prickish. Yeah. You know, I mean, he's always
you
been
like
that way.
You like Bill Maher?
I didn't
I love
say
Bill
I like
Maher.
Anybody.
I don't,
don't
love
be a brown noser.
I'm not a brown noser. I'm just saying, you know.
I never met him. But somebody told me he was really generous.
Well, he didn't give me anything.
he didn't tip you?
He didn't tip you?
I don't remember I got that information. Somebody told me that he was
some
a very generous dude.
Really? I had
hair.
To buy a dollar in the vending machine for
right.
my water.
That's
so
terrible.
There was nothing in the
he,
in my
he wears
dressing
eyeliner
room.
And makeup.
He dates a lot of, you know, what do you call it? Like
younger comics?
Strippers and
strippers.
Playboy bunny
bunnies.
Girls.
You know why?
He used to go to those.
Because he secretly wants to be one.
Right. Maybe he's, yeah.
Are you saying, are you saying he's gay?
I'm saying there's something really wrong with him.
Holy shit.
You open the door and you got more makeup on than me.
That is bad.
And it's a theater. It wasn't even like we're, oh, cut, next
but,
scene. Right.
But the lights were bad. They were really bright.
His audience was, do you think his audience would have noticed that he was wearing makeup?
Of course
I don't
not.
Even think his audience knew who it
I don't
was.
Think I've ever worn makeup on stage.
They bust him in from some.
Now I'm going to have to really examine his
seniors
face.
Say.
Even, well, he's very pale. He's very pasty. Right. And they always put him in like light gray with the pasty and the gray hair. But now they've been putting him, I don't know why I noticed shit like this, but they've been putting him in navy suits and dark, and he looks way right. better. And
he
they've
looks
been
alive.
Putting
yeah.
black, because he does
way
look
better.
Cadaverish. He's not a handsome man. Let's
Would
be
you
honest.
Stay with him for 17 years? That's
no.
what I want to
know. No, I would be at the goddamn door. Yeah. He's short, too. Is he short?
He's short.
Shorter
he
than
is
you,
short.
Right?
He's short.
And he sprays his hair.
Yeah, see, I don't wow. like
okay.
all that.
What?
I need a natural man, for God's sake. Someone who doesn't put a lot of thought into the way they look.
Well,
Tim,
no,
I'm kidding.
No, men put a lot of thought into the way
type.
They look, though. That's the thing.
That's my type.
They have, like, some appearance. You know, they act like they don't, but they
right.
really, really do.
It's really they're thought out. Like, look at Adam with his tight jeans.
I was just looking at Adam as I was saying this.
How hot is he?
It's the hipster. It's the hipster thing with Adam where it's like,
great
it
hairline.
Looks like he doesn't give a shit because he's got the beard growing out. But
sweetie,
you know,
you look
no, but you know what?
You
Hold
know
on
he's
a second.
Like trimming
he's
the beard.
He's growing
That's
the
right,
beard,
sweetie.
But yet he told me it itches like a son of a bitch. But he's still got yeah. it grown because he wants to be hip with what now
right.
The Bachelor has the beard right. on TV.
Oh,
well, it looks
the
good
bachelor.
On you, Adam. It could go. Not everybody looks good in a beard. You know, personally, I don't like the really long, burly beards.
No.
You know
ZZ
that you can
top?
Find anything. You can find a penis or a vagina in the beard. It's completely lost. I like this, where it looks actually very well groomed. That's what I like.
Can I just share? I do not like facial hair on a man when I am trying to kiss them or if they are going anywhere, particularly
yeah,
on
right.
my body.
I'm
because the shit face. Hurts. The it, shit hurts.
I know, but if it's a soft beard, though.
No.
I
get a rash if my husband's face
me
touches
too.
That's, mine.
I don't like, yeah. I know. My fiance, I had to talk my fiance. It took 7 years to get him to shave his
so
goddamn
seven, seven out of the ten,
1970s mustache. He has a mustache. Ooh. Like people would go, are you a cop? Are you a fireman? Because he had one yeah. of those 70s
yeah. Are you the village yeah. people?
Exactly.
I met that guy.
I'm like, I'm begging you. Shave. In the beginning, I would be nice. You know, like you're nice in the beginning before you move in when you're like, oh, it's okay. Mm-hmm. And then you're like, hey, you know what? You'd look good without that problem. He's like, huh. And then ignores you. And then you're like, hey, you know what really bothers me when you go down on me is that fucking mustache. It hurts. Ah, interesting. Hey, you better fucking shave that thing off. Hey, shave it off or I'm not fucking you.
Shave it off or you're out.
That's right. And then he did shave it. I love a clean face on a yeah. man. But I understand that the young, they like the little... You know, they like
this,
a little
that,
beard.
He
it
likes
good. It looks good on him.
I'm going to tell you the difference. Yeah. That is because he cares. He's uh-huh. he's groomed.
Yes. Right.
That is because he's just lazy and it doesn't feel like
right,
shaving
exactly.
his face.
Wait
now,
a minute.
Now, I go to a black barbershop, believe it or not. I go
here.
Once a week.
It's up here. The beard is up here.
Why a black barbershop?
Because that's where I live. I live in Quorum. My son's black friends open a barbershop. I go there once a week and they trim it up. They, you know. Yeah.
And then, what do you mean, once a week is the only time you shave? You don't shave every day?
No.
Guys,
not
like,
unless
oh,
I
don't
take
care.
My shit.
No, it looks like his doesn't grow in as dark. That's
yeah, just trim it up. You have to trim it up. But it's obvious you don't care because you got this thing. How many years now? That,
right,
you know,
gotta look
dangerous.
Get
it's all right. She
out.
Pointed out the scar on my shoulder the first time I worked with her.
Patty apparently went through a windshield.
When she was a child.
I've got scars. she's covered with
up.
Goddamn scars.
What?
I did almost, but anyway, that is too much. Now, what about when you do these tweets? Uh-huh. Do people like sometimes people are so mean?
Right.
Back.
Well,
do you have mean
people
shit
can
said
be
back
very
to you?
Mean to me? Yes. They and at first I would argue with them on Twitter. I would
right.
get into Twitter wars. I'd be like, ooh. "You're a dick." Like it was
right.
horrible. But then I stopped doing that. Now that, it's so great. I just I'm like, "Fuck you, block." Or just
oh,
no,
yeah,
I don't.
Just
why would
people.
You block them?
Because they say really, you know, some
cares?
Of the things are horrible.
No, because people
though.
Can be really horrible, and I don't want that shit on my feet.
Oh,
I mean, really bad. Though.
Yeah,
oh,
but it's not just like
not
I
like
disagree with you.
Right, exactly.
It's like you
yeah.
smelly whore.
Yeah.
You
oh,
no,
I see.
Choke
I love,
on my.
I love that interaction.
I might go,
my best friend used to call me
Facebook
that.
Here and see what's going on.
Really?
I like that interaction.
But what I do, but it gets really bad. If it's really negative, then I get rid of it. But I don't mind. I don't expect everybody to agree with me. And I like that, you know, I don't like hardcore discord, but I don't mind bantering back and forth. You can disagree. That's fine. But once they start getting really vile and gross.
But you don't get blocked. Hurt feelings when they
no,
say the horrible
no.
thing.
Because you know, I was if you came from my family.
Why would
you,
she get, why would she no, get hurt feelings when they don't even know her?
Exactly.
I don't know. Because if I put something
but
up
even
on Facebook and they say something really dicky, I haven't had it in a while, but I had somebody, and then I get hurt feeling. I'm like, oh, I don't even want to look at it. But I tend to leave it up. The only time I take something down, mm-hmm. I had somebody say to some guy that I know who was saying something that was, you know, pro-Trump, and the girl said, go fuck yourself on my thread to the guy who was disagreeing. Mm-hmm. I don't think you should say go fuck yourself just because someone's disagreeing in a
right,
nice way.
Right.
So,
but that's happening a lot on Facebook and on Twitter now.
It does get ugly.
Yeah, it does.
So that's
ugly.
What I was wondering, because you have a lot of balls to say these things.
Yeah. I mean,
and then...
Yeah, you know, I think my tweets come off as crazy as well. And I almost got into a divorce over one of my tweets.
Divorce with your husband?
Yeah, because I tweeted something.
What happened?
So this
is
the
weird
thing with social media, okay? I sort of refrain from posting anything political on Facebook.
Because you're a heavy, heavy Trump supporter.
Because, oh, yeah, of course. Everybody knows that about me. Of course, isn't that obvious? Okay, isn't that fucking obvious? So
I'm also liberal.
So what do I do? So what I don't post on anything because, you know, I live on Staten Island, which is very much Trump land. Right?
Very Republican.
Very Republican. And a lot of my husband's friends are all Republicans.
Yes.
I don't want him giving, you know, he's going to take the backlash of one of my posts. And I care about the way that his friends are going to treat him. A lot of them are retired firefighters. I really love them. I'm friends with them. I don't want my husband to be caught in the middle. So what I do is I'm on Twitter and I told him, I said, Twitter is my domain.
Your safe place.
Fuck that. Okay.
Yes.
So when he went and he was scouring my Twitter feed at some point.
Your husband.
And he found one tweet. He was very upset, and that almost.
What was the tweet? What
well,
was it?
Was, and listen, I'm taking like a little bit of responsibility here because it was during the time that Kaepernick, the football player,
yes,
decided to take
taking
a knee.
Taking a knee, yes.
Right. He was taking a
taking
knee.
Taking a what?
A knee.
He took a knee.
During the national anthem.
The football player during the national anthem.
Oh, he stepped down?
He goes on the knee as disrespect to the flag because Black Lives Matter. That was his take on
that
it.
That was his thing, you know, there's, you know, Black Lives Matter, there's so much racism, so he decided that, you know, whatever, for America, he's like, I'm going to take a knee, right?
Wait, so that's Trump's fault?
No. It's not his fault, but what happened was I tweeted out a tweet on 9/11. About that.
What'd you say?
I was just like, I was kind of like supporting like his right to do what
to
he
take
but
a knee.
My husband, listen to this though. My husband, it was very insensitive on my part because my husband lost a lot of fucking friends on 9/11.
Oh, yeah.
But I didn't.
Was he a fireman? Your husband a fireman?
Yes, he's a retired firefighter. And he's, you know, that's what I mean. It's a very fine line. And so when I did that, I immediately felt really bad about that. I felt really fucking bad about it.
And
genuinely.
You should have.
And I did. And I really did. And I apologize. So, you know, I feel like it's I don't mind saying whatever I want and getting backlash, but I would never really want to hurt somebody, like genuinely hurt their feelings because I was being insensitive. That would crush me.
So what'd you do? Take it down? You just took it down?
I did. I actually deleted it.
And then was he mad after that?
He was a little upset, but then I gave him a blowjob. Okay, he knows that's not true. Okay, that's fine. I'm sorry. That was wrong.
It's
the kids are listening.
It's the great equalizer.
It is. It's the gravitational pull of reality. He's like, you're a lying whore.
Well, you know, a girl's got to do what a girl's got to do.
Listen, you know.
Of course, I can't do it anymore now that I have a plate in my neck. It's very hard.
Actually,
I have to do it like this.
In your neck. What is this? I don't believe that
she has a plate in her neck, but I'm getting one put in because I don't want to do it anymore either. So,
but Carrie, remember how I told you that
Carrie, I don't do it.
Carrie, I can't have sex when my kids are in the house. Now my excuse is gone because my daughter is moving out on Monday. So now I can have sex whenever.
Yeah, and I want to.
Sure, why not? I'm so sad, though, that my daughter is moving out. I'm, like, crying. Your son moved out,
yes? Yes, he lives in Queens.
Well, but both your sons moved out?
No.
Throwing them out is too different.
Carrie, I love the way Carrie is. I love Carrie so much. When I'm on the phone with her, she reminds me of my mother. Well, first of all, I love Carrie. I can't say it enough. I could just spend the
Who doesn't?
Hours. I know. I love you so much.
I have
and
a problem. Sometimes I have a problem.
Same day as my mother. I know, right? Same day as my mother. And when she was on the phone with her daughter, she's like, you know, everybody tries to be so fucking PC. It is really irritating.
Not Carrie.
It's not Carrie. And I love her. She's on the phone with her kids and she's like, I'm going to break your fucking toys. Is that what you want me to do? I'll break everything. And I'm just like, that's my girl. That's how I was raised. My mother was the sage.
I'm like, you fucking think I'm kidding? You fucking think I'm kidding? I'm going to break that iPad. I will break it now.
You know what? When my kids were little, I didn't curse the first few years of their life. And then all of a sudden it slips in and it's like, well, this shit. And then it's like, I'll fucking kill you. Then the fucking comes out.
You're only human.
It's like,
I mean?
You go back to who you really are.
Yeah. Well, in my house, all you hear is, stop it. Stop it. I'm not. Don't go near him. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. That's all you hear in my house all day. That's why I've got 7 jobs, because I don't want to be home.
You are never home. Listen, Carrie, I remember when Carrie made the decision. I will never, ever forget about Carrie. You probably don't remember this. We were in a car together. I think you were turning like 35 or something.
Last year.
Carrie said... 30, yeah, last year. Thank you.
Okay.
She was like, if I don't get a sitcom by the time I'm 40 years old, she goes, I'm going to get married and have fucking kids.
No, here's what happened. I remember when it was. I had just gotten back from Montreal and I had all those meetings lined up in LA.
Oh,
right.
Yeah.
Right.
So now I said to her, if nothing happens after this, of like, you know, because I had just done New Faces.
Right.
And in Montreal. So I had all these meetings.
How did nothing happen for you after that?
Because the business is a bunch of dicks.
No, because then September 11th happened. I got a pilot with Fox. We shot a pilot for Fox that they held for 2 months.
Wow.
It was the new modern day Odd Couple. It was me and Vince Morris. And I was Oscar. He was Felix. It was like Urkel and you know.
You shot a pilot.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and it didn't get picked up. And after 2 months, and then I went into, I read for Greg Giraldo's, the late great.
Okay, yeah.
Greg
Giraldo.
Love him.
Loved him.
And I didn't get that. And then they picked some girl to play a New York bartender that was a skinny little blonde. I mean, I was skinny at the time too, but I was New York.
Yeah.
Hey, who wants a drink? And we're doing a show about the Comedy Cellar that I was there every night.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And they casted some little twitty blonde from L.A.
Is that why you dyed your hair?
Pretty much. That was the breaking point. So, I mean, and they had a fat black guy playing Patrice O'Neill, which, why don't you just cast Patrice O'Neill?
Exactly.
Why don't you just throw cameras at the Cellar and make it a reality comedy?
I always think that they should do that. Not now.
Right, back then.
The Comedy Cellar had a spark. The owner, Manny, was my favorite. I loved Manny.
Really?
He was the whole thing of that place.
Okay.
He would fight about Israel. He was pro-Israel, and he would always fight with all these comics. Greg Rogel would sit there.
Greg Rogel goes crazy on Facebook. Puts up. He doesn't talk about somebody not giving a fuck.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
You saw Falling Down, the movie when Kurt.
No, I never saw that.
Kurt Douglas.
Kevin loves that movie.
And he finally just cracks.
He snaps.
Yeah. Well, that's where Greg Rogel is. He has completely snapped.
I think Greg Rogel is really funny.
There's
a few people like that on Facebook, though.
But you know what happened to him, right? Yeah. He ended up getting.
Greg
Rogel got a permanent spot on The Nanny, and Rory Rosegarden said to him, no way, you're not doing that. We're holding off. You're getting your own show.
You're kidding.
Her voice is not going to last for more than 5 minutes.
You're kidding.
Nobody can listen to
that. And they loved it.
And that show was a hit, and then Greg never got shit. And he would have been a permanent cast member.
And talk about all the money coming in from it's being shown all over the world,
the residuals.
Oh my God!
But, so now he has that heartbreak inside.
Oh,
God. I don't blame him.
He's got the Jameson. Every time I see him, he's got a glass of Jameson. Yeah. I mean, you know, he still can't let it go. But that's the problem in life.
The reliable blowjob won't help
this
at all.
all the girls are gone now because there's no sitcom deal. But when you don't let things go, like the mistakes you made in the past, like there could have been, like I had, we had 2,000 shares of Apple when Apple was like.
Who's we?
And my husband.
Your husband.
Oh, okay.
So 2,000 shares of Apple when it was $24 a share, whatever it was.
All right.
Okay. So I had a lot of shares of Apple. And
all
I go, you know what? Let's sell the shares at what I think it was $40. So we're making maybe $15 a share. And let's open up Gyrolicious, right?
God.
The Apple share has gone to fucking $750 a share. I would have been well over a millionaire had
Are you kidding me?
And you wouldn't have to worry about the health department at all.
Right. Yeah.
Department.
Right. So, or you could pay them off, sweetie.
Had I had I just left those 2,000 Apple shares and sold, you know, you can't look back at what the fuck
you know what
worked.
You never know.
Unless it's that. I'm sorry. Okay, that's a big fuck up. Sorry. Okay, with the exempt, excluding that.
You've always got to think that there's a reason that you open Gyrolicious. Right.
Yes, that's what we tell ourselves till we're fucking downward dog and blue in the fucking ass. Yes.
But maybe maybe your reality show will be you at a place called Gyrolicious. Mm-hmm.
Carrie-licious.
I love it, Carrie-licious.
Why not?
Here's the weirdest part.
Go ahead. Uh-oh.
I do Facebook Lives all the time. I'm just like the other day I had to do a delivery and it really pissed me off that I don't have a delivery driver because nobody wants
to. We have the same problem at the pizzeria.
No delivery driver.
We can't find the delivery guys.
Wait a minute.
Guys.
You work at a pizzeria and you work at a...
No, I don't. I'm pathetic, but not that pathetic.
Well, wait a minute.
I'm one step away from working at a pizzeria.
Wait, why do you know about the pizzeria?
No, I'm only kidding. There's nothing pathetic about working at a pizzeria.
Your husband
owns a pizzeria? Yes, he does. Well, and I just want to take that back. I feel terrible. I did work at the pizzeria.
No, I did. No, you don't take it back.
Okay, all right.
Because... It is pathetic.
I was a waitress my whole life until I started, you know.
So here's what happened.
Me too, sweetie.
She worked at a vegan place.
$20 an hour.
You're not making any money at a vegan place.
They tip
and she doesn't have a tattoo.
She's so fucking shitty at vegan
restaurants. They go, you don't have a tattoo.
They
says, well, I got a plate in my neck. Right. I said, okay, you're hired.
God, you know.
They're horrible.
So, no, I could put it in at $20 an hour delivery driver. I won't get anybody. Anyway, so now I have a delivery.
$20 an hour?
I'll go there. Yeah.
I'm just saying.
You're saying, but you're not really saying.
I'm just saying.
Oh.
Okay. She means $10 an
hour. She means $10.
Hold on a second. $10 an hour plus your tips. These guys are.
Yeah, you make a lot of money on tips.
Plus $2 delivery charge.
Yeah, and I'm doing this for nothing.
Right.
I'm doing this for nothing.
You get the. Lemon potatoes.
That's right, though, Barry.
Yeah,
lemon potatoes are delicious. Priceless.
So now I get a delivery to go to Old Westbury.
Oh, there you go.
Now, Old Westbury is like the richest neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
That's old money.
Yes. Right. Right.
So I pull up. So now I'm in the car. I'm doing a live. I'm like, I got to go to the fucking van. All my live is just me going, fuck. So I'm cursing the whole
way. As you're driving?
And I'm saying, how dare Trump fucking tell these illegals they got to go home?
We're going to fall apart. What a fucking prick. I know.
No, these people need to stay. They need to get a work number. Pay your taxes. Mm-hmm. Pay your taxes. Pay your health insurance. Forced to pay that, and then you should be allowed to stay here. And after 10 years, if you haven't raped anybody or killed anybody, you're welcome to stay.
I agree. Do not split up a family. That's absolutely not the way I feel.
That's horrible.
So this is me doing the rant while I'm driving.
I'm surprised, Carrie.
I pull into this mansion, and there's 90 fucking cars. I'm like, out of all these people, nobody could pick up their food. Nobody. So I'm filming. I pull up to the house. I'm banging on the door. Dobermans. Dogs are jumping. It's literally 15 minutes. I'm banging, ringing bells, cursing the whole time. Are you fucking kidding me? And the wind is blowing. So I go, I'm fucking done. I'm fucking these people. And so then I get in the car. I call them. I get off the live. And there's a part two to the live. And the girl picks up. I go, your food delivery is here. Do you know I've been here 15 minutes. You do know you're waiting for food. Oh, I'm sorry. We're on the second floor. We didn't hear it. I'll be right down. So now I turn the camera back on again. I'm like, this bitch, I want to see who the fuck this bitch.
Did you film her?
Yes, I did.
You did?
No.
He comes out.
Yes.
And his kink Farouk robe on with his
What's a kink Farouk?
Thank you very much.
What is it? Like
a fancy?
Who the
kink
fuck
Farouk.
Wears, you know, like
king
a big
Farouk?
A big like a robe.
Is
like
this
a
Greek
douchebag robe?
Is this a Greek
robe.
King Farouk?
No. No. It's just any douchebag can wear one.
Greek that I don't know about.
I can't believe you never heard of King Farouk.
Never heard of King Farouk.
All right, so
King Tut.
Yeah. No.
Yeah, I've never heard of it. Okay.
So he comes out in his king Farouk robe on. He comes out. And obviously, just
they were doing something.
They were banging away, either that or they were filming a porno because there was 97 cars.
What is going on?
Right. What
so
is going
I go,
on?
Do you
this
want
is...
change? And he's like, no. And now, meanwhile, they don't even make a path to the house. So I slide on the ice, almost killed myself.
Right.
Pulled my bag. You know when you pull one of these and you almost fall?
Yeah.
You rip your whole back
out.
God. And he gives me the money, and I take the money, and I'm just like cursing the whole way. And I tell you, people say to me, your lives are so dumb, but we can't stop watching them.
Right.
You do put a lot of
you
your
do
stuff
a lot,
on,
yeah.
I don't know if I would want people to know about my chin hairs or my...
Oh, I don't care.
I don't...
It doesn't
matter. I don't care, but Facebook Live doesn't interest me, but I'm a Twitter fanatic. That's my disease. So we all have our own thing that you love Facebook Live. I don't really care for Facebook Live, but I love the Twitter.
You know, I put something up on Twitter, I'll get one like, and it'll be Carrie.
I get nothing. I get nothing.
I put up my...
I get absolutely nothing. Make no mistake.
I just like three of yours.
Yeah.
I did my political post that I thought, oh, this is a good one. I'm putting this up. I did a political post that was not so happy about Trump. Zero.
How many followers do you have?
Four. You're one of them.
I'm following you. I'm going to follow you. That's why.
You follow me?
I have like 3,000 people on Facebook, and I have like
I have
350 people. So I just started Twitter.
I'm going to start.
You have 350 on Twitter?
Wait, I'm going to follow you.
All right, good. Yeah. That'll make five.
And you should always, and this is the thing, you should always plug your Twitter handle.
He doesn't
Twitter
know
handle.
What we're talking
about. Yeah, exactly.
Wait, what's
I love
my
it.
Twitter handle?
Can we explain?
What is your Twitter, like what is your, your what
Patty.
Does it say on your Twitter?
I think I'm just Patty Rossborough.
Oh, at Patty Rossborough.
I think so. Okay, what's your Twitter handle?
At Irene Bremis 13.
13. Right.
Yeah. Okay, now he
what's
has
you, what
no
Tim,
he,
Tim
he
Gage has no Pops.
At Tim
oh,
Gage
are,
Pops.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, have it because of Colin. I'd be at work. I'd be unloading the truck, and all these comics would be going, "Are you reading what your cousin's putting on Twitter?" I'm like, "No, I'm unloading the truck. I don't care."
Right,
you know. And
are
then
they
go,
have a life.
They
have
all loved it. They were like, "Oh, he was putting down this person, and you know, he was making fun of this." And now all the people that follow him hate him. They're you know deleting him. And
who isn't he liking? Who's he putting down?
He didn't put you know stuff like when Gaddafi died. He died after Steve Jobs, and he was like, "The world lost another visionary today." people were like, "You asshole!" And like just hate him. And so I got the Twitter, so then I can go, yeah, I read it.
That's funny.
I just said, you know, that's all. That's the only reason why I'm on Twitter.
No right. Do you,
oh, so
tweet
you are on Twitter?
No, I don't.
Right.
Do you have political feelings? Do you feel like I have to tweet this
really,
I want to tweet it?
No.
Whose side are you on?
With what? With what? I'm not a political type. I don't.
Are
you
Republican? You Democrat?
I don't. No, I'm independent.
That's what Kevin is too. What's with the fucking independent?
People
that are unhappy with both sides.
No, here's what I'm going to tell you. What it is?
Okay. Go ahead.
It's all a bullshit game on both sides that are keeping us, you and whoever else gives a shit. Because I don't give a shit. Because no matter what I say, it's not going to make a difference unless you tackle an entire government and wipe it all out. It ain't happening. You're got good cop, bad cop. They both work together, and we think it's like, oh, there's sides. There are no sides. It's their side against our side.
May I disagree with you completely?
Go ahead.
Oh, I'm loving this. A little mud, a little jello, and a pit.
No, I mean, I think things do make a I don't think it's going to make a huge difference in the way that the government is run. The government, you know, but I do think that when people say things, it does make a difference. Mm-hmm.
But you think that the government, they'll give you a little bit of it. If enough people say
that's
it,
right.
Give you a little bit.
That's right. If enough people push.
But because they don't want you to overturn them. So they are working together as a group, as a team, but you don't know it. You don't
When
see
you say
it.
They, you mean the both sides.
Correct. In order to have a successful rule, you know, like, you know,
presidency,
government,
you have to create a diversion of two sides. If you don't, it's you against them.
It's true.
You have to have that. So, you know, 10, 20 years ago, Hillary, Bill Clinton and Trump were best buddies, and he was best buddies with Hillary. All of a sudden, they don't like each other now. It's all bullshit. When you all understand that.
No, I agree, though. I agree with what you're saying, though. Seriously, I do see what you're saying, though, too, Carrie, 100%. But I agree with what you're saying. Like, you have to call them out on every little thing that they do. You have to call them out.
You You have to protest. And also, like I feel like...
Wait, you're going to go protest and get mace in your face? And
who,
your eyes?
Who says I'm going to get mace in my face? I'm not going to be like in a violent protest.
That's how they all turn out.
My daughter did a very peaceful protest.
I didn't know. I went to the march. I went to the Women's March in Washington. It was completely peaceful.
Peaceful.
Children were
everybody,
there.
And everybody was in a good mood.
Madonna was fucking awful, by the way. Okay, we'll talk about that.
Yeah, I didn't think she was so good. Oh, I don't think it's good to just be vile and say horrible things.
But that why would she step out of the norm? Because she's always been vile and disgusting.
Yeah, she is kind of vile. Yeah, I mean, she's not. I was never been
now,
a fan of Madonna.
You know, she's always been disgusting.
I feel like
so
she's still
really
trying
being
to
who she is.
She's still trying to say things to get attention.
Shock.
I feel like
the
everything
shock value.
She
Step
does.
Down, yeah. Lady Gaga's
yeah,
here.
Yeah, yeah,
oh
yeah.
My God.
Right. Exactly. Who
I
is a better is like
more
another,
talented.
She reminds me so much of Madonna, except she has a lot of talent.
She can actually sing.
Yeah.
Madonna
and dance.
Was like
no, no,
what was
sing.
That?
It
was
and
like
play
a
an instrument.
No, Madonna did one thing. Madonna did one thing better than Lady Gaga.
And
it's spreading them.
Whoa.
I did hear that is how she, you know, we don't know, Carrie.
That and the fact that she pretty much, you know what she did? She took everything from everybody that she ever saw, and she was great at like marketing herself.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
No,
yes.
She's a big thief.
And spreading them, though.
She's a big thief.
Mostly,
who'd
yes,
she
a big
steal
thief.
From?
Oh, my God. Everybody. Well, there's everybody, actually. Yeah.
But you know what? She did the shock thing.
She
was dating, what's his name, the basketball player?
I wore those a million bracelets growing up, though.
Oh, yeah, I did, too.
Didn't stop me one bit.
I wore the cross earrings, too.
I wore the cross earrings.
Who was the black guy she was dating?
Yeah.
Who was that?
With the Scottie Pippen?
No, with the dyed hair. He's crazy and he's an
alcoholic. Oh, I know you're talking about Dennis Rodman.
Dennis Rodman.
Right.
Yes.
She said to Dennis,
yes,
you're not going to be anything unless you shock and awe, right? So you have to come up over the top crazy to make a name. She put him in that wedding dress. Remember, he was wearing a wedding dress.
Yes, I do remember.
I thought
he wore that when he married the other girl, though.
No. It was during Madonna. After Madonna Carmen told
Electra.
Him what
Carmen
he
Electra,
had to.
I thought he got wore the white.
But after he got Madonna told him how to do it. How
you
to get
read
the
a lot
attention.
Of tabloids, don't you, sweetie? I see that.
I know Tim knew Carmen Electra. That name came right up.
Well,
I understand.
Really?
She's very hot, Tim.
She's gorgeous.
Yeah, she is pretty hot.
Tim,
yeah.
We want to know, why are you not married? What's going on? What's going on with you and women?
But you have kids, though, right? So you're are you divorced?
No.
Somebody
just
dumped him.
Oh.
Nobody.
Sorry.
Carrie, stop it.
No.
By the way, I'm your biggest fan.
I have to worry about my career. No.
No. Well, do you go on the dating sites? Do you do the Tinder?
No. I'm not even on Facebook. Why would I go on a fucking dating?
Well, you want to meet a girl.
You're not on JD.
No,
for Jews.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
But what about Match.com? Do you want a nice girl to live with?
No, I don't want anybody.
With?
I want to be left alone. That's
seriously?
I agree.
And as he's saying it, he's almost cradling.
Colin said that to me. He goes, I know why you're not dating, because you're happy. You're answer to nobody.
What about a little affection at night?
No.
You want to cuddle? Don't you want to cuddle?
No, but that goes away after a while. You know what I mean?
I love to cuddle.
It goes away after a while.
Well, let's get Kevin in here and find out how much he loves cuddling.
Because she's on the second one. Right?
When we watch TV 15 years in, I go, oh, will you hold my hand while we watch TV?
You have
TV?
To say it.
I do it. Are you kidding? Yeah. He's not going to hold my hand. Yeah. He hates holding
you
my
have
hand.
To do that. You have to.
He hates it. I force it.
He's watching TV eating chips.
Steve, I try to hold Steve's hand, and he doesn't like the way it feels. He has to reposition my fingers.
How about this is what happens.
Go ahead.
Here's what happens. He's eating chips, watching whatever he's watching. He's into it, and all of a sudden she's like, can you hold my hand? Say it to me.
Can you hold my hand?
Exactly.
Oh, it's so upsetting.
That
like
how
you can't
is.
Believe that we're gonna.
When we
why
first,
would you even?
When
yeah.
we first started dating, I would go. We'd be laying in bed or whatever. Go, oh, you want to give me a foot massage because it's so relaxing and it makes me feel. And he'd be like, yeah, you know, because when guys want to get laid, they will massage you. Till the fucking cows come
I
off.
Used to get a breast massage. No, really,
a breast massage.
Yes, I used to for hours.
From
and
your husband,
I'm convinced
from
that
Tim.
It actually got my. Yeah, Tim did it. Sorry, I had to.
That would get you giving milk, maybe.
No, that actually can stimulate and make them larger, I'm convinced. That and eating chicken. That's my mother's advice.
Oh, that's true, because it has got the, what
hormones,
you call it? The
that's
hormones
right.
in it.
Okay, but so
who
you
was
get
giving
the
you
massages?
The breast massage?
Yeah.
Your
my
husband?
Husband?
Oh,
yeah,
your husband.
Long
oh,
time,
I thought
yeah.
you went
before
somewhere
we got
for
married.
It.
Yeah, no.
Hilarious.
No, oh, I wish. Yeah,
Phil,
I might have
Phil
to do
down the block.
But now, when I say to him, will you rub my feet? He's like,
you're
just like
me.
When you said, he's like,
you're killing me.
yeah, later, later. And I go, later, but what's later? Because you're going to be asleep, because he goes to bed at like 9 o'clock at night. Yeah. I go, what do you mean later? He goes, wow. Don't worry. He goes, just let me just relax. And I'm like, okay. And then every 5 minutes, I'm like, now? Because I want my fucking focus on.
Patty.
But I have to force him.
Yeah, yeah.
I hope one day you don't go home and everything's cleared out.
I am horrible to live with. It's true.
No, you don't seem like
let
you
me
are.
Ask, no, I am. Where, I'm annoying. Where is all the water?
Yeah, but Kevin's
you
a great guy.
Oh, behind you.
Because I'm dying.
There's one right behind
is
you.
Is Kevin. Kevin.
Carrie on the wooden thing.
What? Is who's? Is he a comic, no. Kevin?
She's just crunched hers up like a mad
woman. Oh, you
woman
drank yours.
And tossed what? It.
You Kevin, drank those. There's none left.
You crushed it and threw it. Don't you remember doing that?
There might be more. Hold on.
Oh,
did you
oh
bring just three no, for I four of us?
No, I have one right here. I'm sorry. I'm sitting here
no,
on my
she
ass.
She has. She
I
has.
I bought it. I got this one. Look, here. Take this because I got that.
Thank you.
I
got
I
it. She's
I got
it.
Her one, sweetie. I got her one.
Hilarious.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Thanks. I just.
I'm just parched.
This is a commercial break, really,
but
for spring, were, Poland right. Spring.
I drank waters, but you wouldn't know because you were late. You were half an hour late. Okay.
Well, because I had the Board of Health up my ass.
Oh, let's not do
listen,
that.
I have. I don't know how many employees, but I'm always going, put gloves on, put gloves on, put gloves on, put gloves on, put gloves on. I have gloves. I got about 200 gloves, right. Boxes of gloves all over the
all
kitchen.
All over, right.
Yes. Put the fucking gloves on.
Whoa.
What happens? Today, the Board of Health walks in. And I'm getting my nails done. I get a phone call. The Board of Health is here. The Board of Health. I'm not getting up for my nails. All right, whatever. All of a sudden, he's giving her a ticket for not wearing gloves while she's cutting the tomatoes. Oh. I wanted to punch her little head in.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, and meanwhile, things. Carrie, at Zinc Bar, the cat, Holiday, remember that cat? I don't know if you remember the Zinc
Holiday
Bar.
Holiday is the
he
name of the
he used to be, yes. Holiday was the name of the cat, and actually, very famous cat. They made a big billboard on it, about it, on Lafayette, and I fucking hated that cat. I'm like, this cat is famous. Fuck you, Holiday. Anyway, she was drinking from a martini glass of water. The health department walked in, and he never got one ticket.
Really? Because he was
drinking
famous.
From the glass. On the bar, you know what I mean? So
that's unbelievable.
If you have like a relationship with them, you know what I mean? Then
right.
You
gotta grease,
sure
the palm.
Listen,
grease the palm.
I remember walking by in the city, you know how the restaurants close after like at 3:30 in the morning, and I'd watch the mice and the rats on the tables of right. these restaurants.
Yeah.
Well, I'm never eating in there. I'm not gonna eat in there. So I knew which ones had the rats and you know.
When I worked at the vegan restaurant, they had rats. Did I tell this story? They had rats like a chihuahua, like a big fucking rat, and it was in the bathroom.
Wow, they were eating beans? What the fuck? How did rats get that big?
But they were the healthiest looking rats you ever saw.
I go to the toilet in the vegan restaurant. I am lowering my bare ass naked ass onto the seat of it, and I hear this. And I feel like a breeze, like something just brushed up against my ass. I turn around and I see a giant rat swimming in the toilet like he's dry.
Oh,
like, oh my God,
that's disgusting.
I was peeing on him. And I'm like, oh, and I pull my underpants up and I'm like, oh, and I'm trying to unlock the thing and I'm like, oh, and I get out.
I got chills just now. I got chills.
Oh,
God,
and I
did it bite you?
It did not bite me, but I get, God. And we've got a full restaurant, okay? Oh, and I was the waitress there and I go to the guy who was the manager. I go.
It was a giant rat?
It was giant, oh, like a dog,
wait,
like
hold
a
on,
small
how
dog.
How did you not know when you
how
plug
can you
in,
not
wait,
feel
you don't
that?
See what's in the toilet?
I don't know.
Look?
You know what? I was so I what was in a fuck? Rush. I was in a rush because I had the whole full restaurant. I'm the only waitress on the floor because nobody fucking shows up.
Yeah, bitch. But there's a boa constrictor in the toilet.
But he
you're blowing your twat.
Yanked my pants. So the guy, there was this young boy who worked there. He was the one with the things on the eyebrows. You know, they have the
piercings.
I went on one date with him, I will admit, and he was 20 years younger than me. And he fucking didn't pay for my movie, and that was the end of it. And he went inside the movie theater.
Without you.
Inside the movie
while
theater without me.
While you went for
popcorn. While I'm
and
waiting outside.
And you almost lost your vagina to a rat.
Can you? Well, anyway, so that kid with the things on his eyebrows, he... goes, I go, there's a rat in there. He goes, I'm going to get it. I'm going to kill it. I go, okay. Stop. He takes one of these like pitchfork forks that you turn over the vegan sausages with. And he goes in and I just hear gross. Like all this noise, like crashing around. And there's a big sign, toilet out of order. You can't use. And he comes
he
out.
He got bit up.
And no, he's got a paper bag in his hand. And the paper bag is going, shh, 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 oh, like God. Moving all around, like a wild animal inside it. I go, what did you do? You didn't killed it. And he's holding the pitchfork. He goes, I couldn't do it. It had a cute little face.
Oh, my,
and,
oh my
you
God.
You know, vegans.
Vegans are
vegans
so
Vegans can't kill
crazy.
A rat. So he took it out and he put it out on the street, which, of course, is going to go into another restaurant.
No, right. It's going to come back.
No, it's going to come right back one. Because you peed on him. It's territorial.
You have to take that in the car.
That rat knows
drive
he's yours.
It like 10 miles. 10, they say 10 miles. But
10 miles?
Yeah.
To the woods.
It's Brooklyn.
Get it out.
It's Brooklyn. They're all over the place.
It was Brooklyn.
But, you know, that's what my father used to do with our animals. Like, every time we brought a dog
Stop.
Home.
Oh, my God. Oh, I no. got my family to. Yours, too.
He would drive it to, like, exit 60 and then come back home. And then, like,
right.
3 months.
You mean you'd wake up, there'd be no animals?
No
yes,
animals.
That's
We'd
what my
cry.
Family
go,
did,
oh,
too.
Oh, must have ran away. And
that's
then, like,
my
Harry,
family did, too. Oh, my God. Wait, that's what they did.
3 months Terrible. Later, it would have a limp. It would make its way back
no!
half an ear and its tail all frazzled off. Yeah. And it, like, made it through, like, the jungles and it finally made its way back.
That's
and my mother's
so
like,
I
oh, my God.
That your mother did.
Why, what'd they do to your dog? You had a dog?
The same thing, Carrie. This is so weird. Except they did it twice to my cousin Irene, who loved you, by the way. She came to see you at the somewhere on Long Island. But anyways, they did that with her dog. They dropped it off in the middle of nowhere.
That's terrible. Schultz.
And then another time she had a dog, or was it Schultz? And they said that they dropped him off somewhere, and it turns out that my Uncle John later came out and said that he accidentally, he was going
ran
hunting.
Ran it over?
He ran it over. Yep. He was
no,
backing
what
up.
What do you mean accidentally? You think he killed it?
No, he accidentally killed
it. Yeah, no, yeah, he accidentally killed it.
Oh,
yeah.
My
a lot
God,
of
that's
people
horrible.
Do that.
Yeah. Well, when we were little, my dad would always bring home a dog, and it was always like a boxer or a German shepherd. And then me and my sisters were like 5 and 4. We're like, yay, we love that. And then we had a cat, and the dog tried to kill the cat. And of course, my mother says, get rid of the dog. And then we wake up the next day, we're like, where's the dog? And gone. The fucking boxer was gone. He did it twice to us, and then they did it with a beagle, too. And my mother had to go to the hospital. Gone. We like wake up. We go. Where's the beagle? Like we bonded. This is like an animal. Like a.
Why'd the mother have to go to the hospital?
My mother had to go to the hospital for some reason. My grandmother came to my Irish grandmother, who's like mentally ill. Like seriously, like she. Like, okay, I just tell you this one thing about my grandmother. Like so mentally ill. Like she had a scrapbook, and I would go to her house.
Oh no.
And she'd go, Patrick. She'd call me Patrick. I don't know why. And she's from Ireland.
Mentally ill.
Ireland.
Patrick.
And she'd go to me. I want you to take a look at the photo album. Of your family, and she'd show me the picture, and they were all cut out pictures from a magazine, from a Maidenform ad of a woman in a bra. She goes, that's me as a young girl. That's me as a young girl. And I go, what are you talking about, Grandma? And she goes, that's me. She goes, here's your father. And it would be like an oatmeal ad of my dad as a little boy. And I'm sitting there like, my grandmother is fucking crazy. But anyway, she came to watch us when my mother was in the hospital, and she didn't want the dog around, so my father got rid of the dog. Oh. And we woke up, and there's no, 3 times we lost dogs to them.
Yeah.
Just
yeah.
And they, how can you do that to a kid? It's terrible.
I find it very easy. I just, you know.
Yeah, just we're going for a ride. Get in the car.
That is so sad.
Right.
You have no
idea. Either
animal.
I'll just run him away or I'm going to kill him right in front of you. What do you want?
Now, wait, your kids don't live with you anymore, right?
No, I have a 26-year-old that's still at home.
Oh,
but
yeah.
I'm living somewhere else and he's.
What do you mean you're living somewhere else?
I live at my cousin's house. He's living in Amsterdam for a couple of years. And
wait, he lives in Amsterdam.
Why don't you live in your own house?
Because I'm watching his house because he has a dog.
Wait a minute.
So you're living there full
you're
time?
You're living in Colin's house?
No. My cousin.
Oh, another cousin.
Oh, yeah, another
like
cousin. Colin
Irish.
Isn't the only cousin,
have,
sweetie.
Yeah, I have 52 first cousins.
50? You do know.
Yeah,
other family.
Do.
Irish
yeah.
motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Kevin's one of 8. He's one of
yeah.
8 kids.
Yeah.
10
yeah.
in a little teeny
Steve
house.
Is one
and
of
he
five.
Won't rub your feet?
Yeah.
And he won't rub your feet.
You believe that?
1 of 5, yeah.
He's
his brother
to rub my feet. One of his brothers will. I
if you're it. Not going to do
no,
one,
I did.
Then
I had
I'm
dogs. I had
Sean.
Dogs, all that stuff. I've had it all.
Did ferrets, you get rid of ferrets. Dogs on your kids?
No,
ferrets.
I
ferrets are like rats.
Yeah,
I never understood the ferret
ferrets
thing.
And,
they're like rats.
Yeah,
birds.
I don't know why people like the
yeah, people like ferrets. I still can't get over the fact that you peed on a big giant rat and didn't see it.
I just started. It was like the quick, and then it was just up. It was so,
so
scary.
Tim.
Yes.
Let's talk more boy stuff.
Poor Tim is just like, what did
okay,
I even
well,
take the half day
No,
off?
No, we're going to talk to Tim.
These
how was your day
are
off?
Not letting me
I'm
gonna
talk. Go, I'm going to go. No, I'm going to go to work tomorrow. Go, how was your day off? Just wonderful.
Wait, Tim, here's the thing. I looked up stereotypes of Greeks and Irish. And
yes.
I want to give you some stereotypes. You tell me if these are true for you. Yes or no, Tim?
All right.
All right, you ready? Drink too much. This
not
is
anymore.
But what, are you an alcoholic? Is that
yes.
What, yes, me too. Okay. Okay. We both checked that off on the stereotype. Right. Here
well,
we go.
So am I. But
check, check. Check. Colin are you also always an
says
alcoholic?
That there's, no, Colin always says that there's two type of Irishmen. The one that are in the program and the one that aren't.
Exactly. Yeah. Okay. And see, Greeks are not alcohol, but you are an alcoholic, you think? You no longer drink.
I don't know.
No, she doesn't drink.
Do you drink?
Yeah, I do. I mean, I used to drink a lot more. I like wine, red wine.
Oh, okay.
And I do, but I don't. I mean, I can't drink like I used
you drunk,
to.
You
no,
he don't drink every
I
get, day yeah, like no, I was every day.
It hurts.
Yeah, crying, it really literally hurts, but I do love the red wine.
When the bottle runs out.
Give him the next one.
Go okay, on. Next one. Gift of gab.
Not me.
Yeah, that
is you. He hasn't said two fucking words this whole show.
But I make up
gift
for it for
gab.
Him. Gift of gab must be for just the women because I never shut up. All right. So that's a zero on that one. Okay. This is me, but I don't know if this is you. Love to complain. That's my middle name. Love
yes.
To complain.
Yes, you do.
Yeah. When do I complain?
You're complaining right now by asking.
You're complaining that, right. Well, you're complaining that you had to take days off from work.
Well,
you
yeah,
half a day
complain.
Off from work.
I complain. To be- I yes. All right. I can't. Yes,
you are a complainer?
Sure.
What's your top complaint?
That he has having to take
do
off iPod, work.
Having to do podcasts for fucking nobody.
Because I
nobody's
going to
see the freaking
are you
thing.
Kidding? We've got at least 9 people watching
you I threaten you.
That's yeah, Facebook Live for God's
no, no,
sake.
It is because I did Kevin Brennan's podcast.
You were very good on Kevin
thank
Brennan's
you very
podcast.
Much, but I figured I have to do this because then they'll say he doesn't do girls' podcasts.
That's what we would have said. That's what we would have said. All right, just a couple more. Here we go. Okay, Gift of Gab is a no. Can't take a compliment.
100%.
Right?
Yes. No. I mean, I will. I do this. I was talking this in therapy. If I am at a show and somebody says, oh,
good
you
job.
Funny,
you're
funny,
like,
great
oh.
Job. One person comes up and goes, you know, I thought you were a little crushed. Done. Oh. I don't want to know nothing. You know, the 100 other people didn't even count. That one negative
why
thing.
Why is that, though?
I don't
why
know.
Are it's, we so negative?
Because your grandmother shows you pictures of people and says it's her. And,
right. And it's a maiden lady in a brassiere. The fuck? Okay, how about this? Obsessed with death. That is
no,
me.
I really don't care about
oh
it. I mean,
God,
I'm not,
really?
I don't care. I'm ready to go. I mean, if I go, I go.
But do you think about it every day? I think about it every day. I talk
no.
About it every
I
day.
Am
no.
Too.
Are you too?
I worry
I
about that one some other time.
Maybe you've got some Irish in
yeah,
you.
I was
go to Ancestry. go to Ancestry.com.
Yeah, I probably have Irish because I'm obsessed with it.
I think about it all
what?
The time.
Like, in what way? Like
death, what happens, where we go.
Oh, I'm obsessed with that aspect of death. But is that how you meant it?
No, I mean,
like
I think about
life and what happens to
that
the
you're
self.
Gonna die.
I think, like, I was talking to Kevin the other day, and we were watching TV, and this whoever it
was,
Johnny Cash.
Was he massaging your feet while we were watching?
No, he wouldn't. He fucking wouldn't.
He was holding her hand. How's he gonna massage and hold her? He'd rather hold her hand.
Johnny Cash yes. Died 3 months after the love of his life died, yeah, and yeah. I said to Kevin, I go, that's because he was so dependent on her. I go, that's exactly what's gonna happen to me because I don't know how to do anything without you. You'll die. I'll be dead right after that. I have a conversation right. Like that almost every day. Mm-hmm. I think about
no,
when
he's
not
going to happen. No.
That
to
I'm going
to
die no, after. I can't function. Yeah. What if somebody dies?
That's going to happen to me because he's a lot older.
He how much older is
well,
you?
Well, not a lot. I'm just
how
kidding,
much?
Honey. 10 years.
Oh, that's not that
that's
much
not
older,
too bad, right? But right. Enough to probably get a head start on death. I think.
Sorry, sweetie. I love you. That and the, you know, little
yeah.
Drops of...
Yeah, that's right.
You know, sun.
The Visine.
My cousin's neighbor was dying cancer.
Yeah.
And his wife, they've been together since they were 12.
Yes.
And they're at that deathbed, I swear this happened. And she's like, I don't know what I'm going to do without you. I really wish I was going with you now. And he goes, Colleen, give me 5 minutes alone.
That's hilarious.
That's really funny. That's great. I love it. I love it. All right, one more. Fighting Irish. Do you get in fights with people?
No, I don't. I'm not that. I'm
you
very,
are not even fucking Irish then.
No, I am. I mean, like, no,
you
I'm
don't
not
fight
I'm not the type
anybody?
Of guy. No,
I
mean,
I don't know Irish.
I've been around a lot of people that are like that. Yes.
I don't mean fist I mean, fights, but like just, you know, you people piss you off, you tell them to go fuck themselves.
No, I'm not that way.
Oh
no,
my
he was not he's not a, he's not drinking anymore, but when you were you drinking, were you like this?
No, I'd be very I well, could be very sarcastic
you
and
were
very mean.
At one point because your wife
very
left.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, Carrie, so hurtful. No, no but
I did that with my son. My son came to me. He goes like, I don't know what I'm doing with my girlfriend. I don't know what's going on. I'm like, You're talking to the wrong fucking guy here, pal. I can't help you.
That's like, yeah, no,
you can't give advice.
I fight with my kids used to get mad at me, and then I'm going to do the Greek one. Mm-hmm. My kids used to get so mad at me because I would get in fights with people and like mothers of their friends, you know, because I'm in the car. She's
like
banging
that.
On the window. Move your car up. Move your car up. And I'm like, move your fat fucking ass. Right? And then the woman.
Your third graders are in your backseat. Yeah, carpooling. That's nice, Patty.
My youngest daughter is crying in the car. She goes, why would you embarrass me? Like, oh, she. And then I'm like, a 2-year-old. I'm like, she banged on the window first. She started it. My daughter is crying. And I'm like, and I had to like really. Like try to not tell people to fuck off when I wanted to say fuck. But you girls look like you're fuck off girls, even though you're okay.
Yeah, Carrie, I would
here
say,
are the Greek
definitely.
Stereotypes. Get ready. We're starting with the number one. Hairy. Your men, and they said also the women too on this.
I'm not. At
she had
all.
Hair on her cheek.
Yeah, you're not hairy.
No, she had it on her face.
Hold on.
List.
I'm not hairy either.
Yeah, you're not either.
No, yeah, look.
Okay, then just the men. The men are hairy?
Not hairy.
What about your husband? Is he your husband Greek?
No, he's not. He's Irish.
I actually shaved this off my husband's back and made a pair of boots.
I do not think your husband is that hairy.
Okay.
Okay, here's one that fits. Loud.
Yes.
No.
I'm. Yeah, we're so loud, right? It's so true. And my mother is deaf, so I'm extra loud. Yes.
Loud, right?
We don't. Yeah, yelling is how we speak.
That's the norm.
Put your fucking gloves on. She was cutting a tomato without her gloves on.
I like your impression of Carrie. I like
everybody has the same impression when they do this. It sound like
I told him. Ah, that's my. I told him not to.
Put gloves on. Yeah.
All right. Here's the next one. Mama's boy, daddy's girl. Carrie. Yes.
Absolutely.
Mama's, and
wait,
you?
What was it that? What
mama's boy. You, you daddy's mother, girl?
My
boy.
Mother revolves around my brother. And that, that's, I revolve
oh, my mother too. But my mother revolves around my brother because he's severely autistic.
He is.
Yes.
Even if he wasn't, she would have.
She would have. You're right. I mean, there's a saying in Greece, if you don't have a son, you don't have a kid.
Oh my God.
Aren't
that's
they lovely?
Terrible.
That's a wonderful foundation
so
for confidence, isn't it?
How was it growing up with your brother? Oh, wait, you did a one-woman show about this, right?
Wow, yeah. How did you know about
that? I did my research. I was going to ask you about it.
I love you so much.
That's right. What was your one-woman show called?
It was actually called Born a Winner. Born a Winner.
And it was about growing up with your brother is autistic.
Autistic, yeah.
And your father is too?
Asperger's, yeah.
Asperger's. Mm-hmm. So
severely Asperger's. Dead now, but God rest his
soul. He's severely Asperger's. Yeah. How was that?
It was like have
you didn't
seen
know it?
It
back then, though, right?
You didn't know it back then. No, not at
oh,
all.
You,
I mean, it was
oh,
just
that's
a,
true.
You know,
you didn't know like no, what Asperger's was.
They didn't
back
know
then.
What Asperger's
you thought
was.
Thought it was normal Greek guy.
Yeah, just oh, a normal yeah, Greek, Greek guy. My mother got set up. It was an arranged marriage. So yeah, basically my brother was just classified as retarded or retard back in the day.
Oh my God, is
he I know
still
it's terrible? But that's what they used to call. You know,
I know
there
that's
was no. There was actually no label for autism or. Asperger's. Yeah, it was interesting. My mother, you know, didn't know my father was really Asperger's. She just thought it was an arranged marriage. So when she came over, she just thought all Americans were like my father. Oh my very God. Sad.
Was she in love? Were they in love? Did
oh.
she get past the kooky part
no,
of him?
No, no, they weren't. They weren't really in love, and they used to fight a lot.
Oh no!
Up. Yeah, it's terrible. My God, this is turning into a therapy session.
Oh my God! No,
no
but it's
but
just
no,
so
no,
interesting.
You're right. Yeah, it was really she. Yeah, so she. It was
yeah,
an
but she
marriage.
Still has to give you $100 when she's done talking about it.
Bill me exactly. Whoops.
But now your one-woman show, was it a comedy show
no,
about
this?
No,
it was a comedy show, yeah. It was. It wasn't just only exclusively about my brother. It was also about my sister. And basically, it's called Born a Winner because when I was born, I actually won a baby beauty contest.
That is so... What is a baby beauty contest?
That was my crowning
now,
achievement.
How do you top
that was my crowning
baby
achievement.
Staten Island.
I actually... No, I was in Massachusetts. There is no baby Staten Island. I'm not from Staten Island. But I'm like, this is... And so the whole premise starts like that was my crowning achievement, and I couldn't top that. So it's been downhill since then. I actually peaked when I was an infant. And
do you have pictures of you as the baby winner?
I had
the
like
beauty?
A little crown
oh
and
my
a sash.
God.
Adam, can we get that up on the screen?
Yes, get that. Pull that up, Adam, please. So Adam, we can take a look at that.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so it no, but it's about my whole entire family and just growing up in a Greek family, and a lot of it is about my brother and my father having an Asperger's and
wow, two people and, in the family.
Yeah, it's crazy. I like to make the analogy that it's like Asperger's is like having HIV and autism is like having full blown AIDS.
Oh, that's like the difference. Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah. Okay, so like this one is a little bit more, you know, quiet.
You can live with it.
You can live with it. And you're high functioning.
And function. And
but, you know, autism is obviously really severe. He's very severe.
So when you brought kids back to the house and you said, this is my dad, could your dad, like, talk to them and say hi? And
of course. No, he could. You know, he could talk to people. It wasn't like that. He was just, like, very socially aware. I really love him.
Social,
yeah. He was just very socially unaware.
I see.
He always looked like he escaped, like, narrowly escaped, like, a hurricane or something. Oh. He looked very disheveled.
Yes,
you know?
Yes.
But I loved him.
Like half the comedians out there.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so which exactly. are all, now we're finding out, so many of the, you know, now, not just comedians, but so many people are diagnosed with, you know, are on the spectrum and have, like, very, you know,
that is true, though, but back when we were little.
Exactly.
Kids were put in the corner because they weren't paying attention.
Exactly.
You know, it was like
I'm
terrible.
Dyslexic.
Yeah, that's right.
ADHD. Yeah.
That's true. You didn't learn to read till you were,
21.
I mean.
You still don't read, do you?
No,
I'm just
really.
Kidding. All right. No, you're reading the dictionary.
Yes.
No, I'm dyslexic. And no, the thing
you
is
had
that
a priest
to,
teach you to read or something
right? No, I had some.
Was it a priest?
No. No.
Why did you tell me something about a priest?
That sounds very scary. Okay.
I don't want to talk about that.
That's another Irish stereotype. You didn't bring up that Irish stereotype.
Wow. No, I didn't learn how to read 21, but I do that on stage where, like, you know, there was no ADD, dyslexia. There was no excuse. You were an idiot, and you handle like a man. That's all you do is sit in class, and that was it. You're an idiot. And you sit in the corner. You know, whatever.
Right.
I was
humiliated.
I was lazy. I was dumb. I was stupid. I was, you know.
Nothing's terrible. Changed.
That's right. See?
Carrie.
I'm sorry. I love him.
All right. Okay.
Well, I would make sure my workers had their gloves on.
Wow, snap burn. All right, two more of the stereotypes. Smokers, they say Greeks smoke constantly.
The men, I don't think the women so much. I did smoke and I quit. Carrie, did you ever smoke?
I didn't and I quit.
Right, yeah.
Why is that a Greek thing?
Oh, my God, you go to Greece?
That's what they said.
The men
smoke. They start at 13.
You go to the hospital and you're like, you know, you got a, you know, gash and you got to get stitches. And the doctor comes in and he's like...
With the cigarette hanging from his mouth. Ashes.
You're kidding me.
You know, people are all smoking in the hospital rooms. There's no.
Right. That's what they said, a Greek thing.
They don't have cancer in Greece.
What do you mean?
Yeah, you don't get cancer in Greece.
But wait, they smoke like that and they don't have a lot
of... No, they do. They do
get
number
cancer.
One. It's like them and Russia.
Really? Is it?
Number one on lung cancer. Yes.
Greece?
Greece and Russia. Look it up!
My father fucking smoked his ass off and never had
cancer. Google it.
I'll Google
what did,
it.
What did he die of then?
He died of kidney failure.
Oh, okay.
And from he never smoking. Drank a fucking drink in his life. Isn't that
That's
ironic?
Weird.
Yeah, so he never had one
from
drink.
From smoking.
And he died of, Or no, the hospitals killed him, but that's another show. Yeah. You know, it was one of those things. Yeah.
Oh, that's horrible.
Yeah, exactly. Super pubic.
Pubic?
I'm sorry. That's just the procedure that finally did him in.
So
it's not like
name?
Some fucking hair that
Don't
was really
tell me
heroic.
Taking okay, it up the poop.
Yeah, please. Only once. Thank you very much.
Only once. All right, here we go. Carefree. That's the last one. Carefree.
Nothing carefree about us.
Really?
No, I'm very carefree.
I think Carrie is kind of carefree, honestly. Carrie could give a shit. I go, Carrie, doesn't this bother you? She goes, fuck no, I don't care.
Oh, carefree like that? But there's a difference, though, between stiff upper lip and carefree. Like, carefree, like, it means that you'll never have, like, any stress at all. That's carefree. Like, no matter what's going on in your immediate family. Well, maybe you are carefree.
I feel like Carrie,
I'm not.
Everything rolls off her back.
You are carefree. You are carefree. I need to be more carefree, actually.
What they go to me, how do you
be more carefree?
How do you do your lives like early in the morning when you look like shit?
I'm I got to be more carefree.
Really?
They don't say that.
Yeah, they do. Who gives a shit?
I don't enjoy George.
Nothing matters. Yeah, I don't enjoy George. Who gives a shit? Who gives a shit?
Can I tell you, I get nothing rolls off my back. And I get so insulted when people say things about the way I look or whatever.
You're gorgeous,
sweetie. This woman that I work with at the antique store, she goes to me, oh, huh. She goes, you looks like you dyed your hair. And I go, yeah. She goes, do you like it? And I go, Yeah. And she goes, huh. Like, don't fucking bring it up, bitch. She's missing, you know, teeth and everything else. Like, I'm not pointing out. And I go, yeah, I do like it. And she goes, and then every time I walk by her during the day, she's like, huh, I just can't get used to it. It's like, oh, fuck you. Yeah. And it gets me so angry. Like, why should I care what
well,
this
I
woman...
would have said, what I would have said to that one, I can't get you. I would have said, well, thank God you don't have to fuck me.
Why didn't I think of that? Where were you when I needed
because
you?
Because you're Irish and you... can't take anything. You only take the negative. That's all you do.
I know the negative soaks. That is true because the other four women who work at the antique shop
oh,
are always like,
wonderful.
I love your blonde hair. And she goes, I love the blonde mixed in with the brown. And even when that woman said that, the other girl, Anne, who works there, goes, I love your hair. But that one, she just won't.
Jealous.
Yeah, she
jealousy.
Won't stop.
Catty.
Mean. Mean. Can't take it. And then I had a dream because of it last night. I woke up that I
wow.
I had a
she really
dream.
Is Irish.
This is how much I drove up. I drove
but you're
up.
Obsessing I gro- over I, this. You I, should be obsessing over the fact that Kevin doesn't want to marry you, and you're
yeah.
obsessing.
Maybe
over
maybe
the
you're deflecting, sweetie.
Leave Kevin alone.
She said, "Thank you." Yeah. See how men always stick up for each
they
other.
Do.
You know what was really funny that I have to say Kevin that Adam did out. Last week when I was talking about the story with Kevin. He said that he had felt fake tits before, like. Breast implants. And I'm like, oh my God. I go, maybe I shouldn't. I said to Adam after the show, maybe I shouldn't have said that because, you know, maybe he'll be mad that I said that he had felt up some stripper's tits. And Adam goes, you know, it doesn't necessarily mean that he felt up a stripper's tits. It might mean that she was leaning against his
lap
arm.
Hands, sweetie, that's
that
it.
She was leaning against his arm. But how much is that a guy sticking up for another guy?
Yeah, it's sick.
You don't even know Kevin and you're sticking up for.
Really?
Yeah, his shoulder felt it. I'm sure. Mm.
So, yeah.
Is that what you tell your girlfriend?
Sure. He wasn't sticking up. He was projecting. It's different.
is that what you
He's
tell
projecting.
Her?
There you go, sweetie.
Men always
what
stick
time?
Up for men.
Well,
yeah, what do we got?
Where are we at?
Oh,
good. We have...
We're done.
Ooh, all right. Oh, wow.
Minutes.
Awesome.
3 minutes to wrap it up. And you guys were fantastic.
We love you.
Listen, I'm speaking there was for no way I wasn't going to have her on, and there was no
love
way.
Her.
I'm
love
sorry,
him.
Kevin. I'm sorry
I'm not,
that I'm here.
I'm not
I'm
taking
sorry
another
that I
half a day ever
and Kevin
again.
Brennan, we love Kevin Brennan, but
did you hear
what did he say?
Kevin Brennan. You got to listen. He goes,
oh, wait, what did you say?
I said I'm not taking another half a day again.
I'm sorry I took a half a day.
That is so hurtful. So hurtful. So who wants to say where they're going to be this weekend?
I'm going
to
be with you this weekend.
Oh, my God. Yeah, we're going to be together.
Jesters.
Jokers.
Jesters.
Jokers
in Chester.
I've
Jokers.
Never even Joker heard of Chester. These clubs.
I've heard of
you
Jesters. You want to work there?
No.
Jesters.
No.
You want to work there? I'll put a word in for you. It's, I think
Hilarious.
It's Jokers. It used
Jokers
to be
Jesters.
Where is it? In White Plains?
No.
No, it's in Chester,
Chester
New York.
Chester, New York.
How far?
40 minutes from my house, but maybe
about an hour
from
40.
You.
Is that about an hour and 40 for us.
Yes.
Yes.
He loves Trump.
We've gotten into like fights on my Twitter feed.
You know what?
Oops, there you go.
I always thought Walt.
Guess you're not working there, sweetie.
I'm so upset about it, really.
I always thought Walt
I weighed that in when I was fucking Twitter warring with him or whatever that was.
That guy Walt in his Facebook picture yeah. looks like Angel Salazar. If I don't have my glasses on, it looks like a little
God,
Angel.
No.
Angel
no.
Salazar.
No.
With
no.
the white hair. He's no. got white hair.
Well, I don't know. Maybe I haven't.
Angel's
yeah,
got
right.
white hair. When did Angel no, get white
well,
hair?
Well, he has dyed blonde
hair. Blonde hair.
Yeah, it's blonde. Like platinum blonde.
Oh, wait,
platinum.
Angel Salazar dyed his hair?
Platinum. To, be, oh my God. To look like Madonna when he does the Madonna
No, my God,
thing.
He right. wants to be. No, really? Maybe he's just coming out now. At 80. That's amazing. Good for you, Angel. Better now. It's better than being dead.
Exactly.
Right.
What was I going to say? Yeah, but
know.
But you he's when you work for him, it's hard because you don't want to say anything. You know, when he always goes on my, like on my birthday, he always sent a picture, yes. a thing saying, you know, Trump wishes you happy, but he always has to push it
yeah,
in.
It's
like,
funny.
It is funny. I actually think it's funny. He's the one that somebody said, fuck you, but it's him just being funny.
Right.
So it's like, I don't, you know what I mean? It's like, you can't.
Well, no, he was being like very, with me on my thread, like I wrote something, I wasn't being contentious at all. Trust
right.
me when I tell you, right?
And then,
but when you write stuff, it sounds like it
see,
because they
but
don't
no,
know
I wrote,
you.
Believe me, trust me. When you go, I'm going to show it to you so that you see. Because, like I said, I really lay off of the Facebook because I know that it's a forum
it gets ugly.
Where it can get really, really ugly. And
yeah.
I understand that we have mutual friends. Believe
yeah, yeah.
me, I do weigh in these kind of things because
yeah.
I don't want to go psycho crazy. But I did write something, and then he came at me, and he was just like he was really challenging me and everything I thought. I was just like, I don't want to fucking do this with you. All right,
you just
it was almost like you
I
were
running.
Wait
do this
wait
with
a
you.
Minute. It was almost
like
you were running for president.
It was almost that way. Like, he was running for president, and or I was running for president. Yeah, right?
You know what I find when people disagree with me on it? If
like
I do any kind of political
post, terrible.
I just leave it alone. I don't respond to it. Who cares? I put up what I think, right. And other people can say what they think, and who cares?
I finally actually said that to him. I said, you know what, Walt? I can't do this with you.
We'll
I'm not trying to change your mind. I really am not. Honestly, so, you know, I like you, whatever. I'm not trying to change your mind.
Right.
And then he laid off. He goes, okay. You know what I mean?
Because
I'm not
like,
trying to change his mind.
I'll go on Facebook and I'll do a Facebook Live. I'll be like, listen, stop with your political fucking posts because no one gives a shit.
I like political posts.
Yeah. And you know what? For the most part, no one does give a shit. You know
no
what I mean?
No one gives a shit. Listen, I have to go to Gyro every day. I have to get my kids. I got to take them to karate after karate. I don't give a shit what Trump's doing right now. I don't care.
No, you
I
have to
care.
Give a shit.
I don't.
Yeah.
I don't.
You have to give a shit, but no one cares about individual posts,
difference.
I think. But you
have
to give a shit as a whole.
It's not
going to
make a difference when you all figure that
somebody
out.
Somebody typing this down.
Please do.
It's not.
This is where
make...
Carrie and I disagree.
Yeah.
We disagree.
But I like it. If you guys agreed on everything.
But I love Carrie. We disagree.
Boring. You know what I mean? Yeah,
exactly.
You have to have
darling.
Fire, sweetie.
Yes.
Darling, I love that. She reminded me of Cynthia Levin just then. Okay. Darling. Okay.
I love Cynthia Levin is very funny. Where are you going to be?
Okay, I post my shows. I've got a big show coming up at the Hookie Lao. Sorry, it's so big, I can't even say it. On March 8th, and I'm at Greenwich Village Comedy Club. I post everything on Twitter and Facebook.
Okay.
Irene Bremis 13.
Bremis 13.
I'm with Danny Cohen.
Oh, I love Danny.
Jody Wasserman.
What? You lucky bitch.
You are not.
She's blonde.
That's great.
She called her Jody Wiener. And
I know. I heard that.
She gets
that.
Very upset.
I know.
But anyway, so I'm with them at Gyro.
Oh, you're doing Gyro.
That's a great
show.
Yeah, that's a great show.
And
I
have gotten 75 texts from Jody how much the money is.
Oh, yeah. And you will continue to get those text messages.
Minute set. I want exact money that everybody else is making.
Oh my God. Already she thinks that you're not going to, like, Jody. Shame
hilarious.
On you, Jody.
That
Carrie
is
would
hilarious.
Never do that. And she's paying you in gyros. Okay, just so you know.
I said you're getting two gyros and a Coke.
I'm telling you, the food is worth it alone.
I'm with Jim Florentine tomorrow.
Oh,
Jim and Jim.
I love Jim.
I would have had the weekend, but I'm with you.
You're
on
with
Saturday.
Me
yes,
on Saturday. So.
Where are you guys
going to
be?
Governor's tomorrow night.
Governor's right.
I love Jim and Jim. I wonder if he would do our show.
Why
would
he?
Why wouldn't he? He knows you for many, many years.
Woods, wherever the fuck we are.
Well, does he live in Manhattan?
Woodside.
Woodside. No, he lives in Jersey.
It's Woods.
He'd have to really drive.
He might be, I don't know where he is.
Well, maybe we could do a remote. Can we do a remote somewhere? Yeah, Patty.
Wouldn't that be weird, though?
You guys can travel.
No, we get the, he's got the stuff. We'll go
guys if it would be at your house.
Yeah, we could do it at the Stress Factory one day.
Yeah, that's only 3 hours away from my house.
How convenient.
Holy shit.
Well, hopefully you'll be booked there, and I'll be booked there, and we'll do
he
it
He never
right
books
after
me
the
there.
No, he's going to. He
oh,
loves
yeah?
you.
Okay.
We'll All see. Right. Anyway, wrap it up, Patty.
Wrap it up. Oh, and also, Adam, you want to make your plug? The Rec Room.
The Rec Room in Woodside.
Woodside, Queens. Adam Hinnitzer?
Hinnicker.
Hinnicker.
Adam Brennan.
That would be funny.
So much easier.
Hinnicker. Thank you. Who we have on next week? Carol Montgomery, right? Carol Montgomery.
Ooh,
who
I
else?
Love her.
Oh, I love Carol.
Who else? Yeah, I should have this written down.
Yeah, it would be nice.
You know, we do have two very funny females.
I know who
Marla
it is.
Schultz.
Oh,
no,
I love
Marla Schultz is the following.
Oh, no,
week.
Veronica Mosey.
Veronica Mosey,
oh,
you are correct.
I love her.
I love Veronica Mosey. So Veronica Mosey and Carol Montgomery next
All
week.
All right. Well, hopefully you'll join us. We're good.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Sweetest.